The button has been pushed. Say hi. Hi.
Hello.
What the fuck is up, everypony?
Welcome, all ye who might be watching, to MLPTG, the Bannermains campaign. Joining us here today is the illustrious Cher. Say hi.
No.
That's good enough. Moonplanter.
How y'all doing?
Tangent.
Oh, meow.
That's the one. And the ringed one herself.
Hello.
And of course, our dude in Kieran.
The horn sounds like a Discord notification now. Fantastic.
Yeah. Getting us started, as per tradition, I'm going to go ahead and read the log from our last session, courtesy of Grot, the gobbo in the party, and effectively one of the prime relationships the Bannermains has to the gobbos who have been stockpiling and stealing fireworks from passersby.
Meet the ponies, eat the bird, join our boss's raiding herd. Steal Glop's grife and set him free, we join the Ringed One's killing spree. Find the battle boss, it cowers in fear, for Ringed One we cheer and cheer. Fight Night Crumper's loyal dog, war boss spares the coward dog. We follow boss, we drum and sing, Glop bog sings with his sling. Ringed One commands red for stern. Boss will take the green throne. To a ship boss leads a raid. We scream and charge to Ringed One's aid. Find some treasure, kill some lizards. Gobs rest well and eat their innards. Find Grop's stash of splody bits. To burn downtown when boss permits. Steal some grub and grab some nails. Travel all day and search for sales. Find bad green in a trap. A strike from war boss, nick or snap. Boss looks happy with glowstone, like when Grot gnashes pony bone.
And with that synopsis from our dear goblin friend.
That was great, but can you say that again, but in English this time?
No.
What, you didn't read it?
Yeah, didn't you read it?
Yeah, weren't you reading along with?
I can't read. I never learned how.
Oh, man. I'm sorry you don't speak goblin, man. That's all I'm saying. That's all.
Rita. Okay. So Moon. Where's the pool? Rough of Men's.
Spectators, by the way, I had posted the I posted the stream link in general. It's also on.
No, Slack. They don't get to know the rough events. They only get to know the goblin summary.
Much chicken bribery was had. Moon Planter was a chicken eating contest.
Yes. Given that our dear friend Tangent had doubled back toward Alverton, she seems to have come back just a bit early now with friends. Our good friend Cher, who seems to have possibly been on the way already. Look at that. As well as, with her, a little dude in Kieran. I would think, likely making Cher a bit annoyed. They have now appeared, as you guys awake on this 46th day of First Moon.
Welcome back.
First Moon.
Yeah.
So I'm still reading. Right. I don't know where you guys are.
Oh yeah. So out of character,
but it doesn't say like where you guys are. Hang on. Air Camp Appleton.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. I would think that Tangent would have caught you up, so you guys catch these guys up here. Out of character here, just so they're a little bit in the know of what's going on here.
What's the difference between Grop and Grot?
Grop is the NPC. Grot is the goblin.
Okay. They are both gobbos, which are little pony goblins.
Yeah, they're gobbos, to be specific.
Yeah.
Since when can you read fortune? She's never read our fortune.
Well, I mean, I figure she would have done it at times, you know. Grot was new.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Grot had effectively been the translator for the captured griffin, who is lazing about in a prison cell, loosely guarded, for lack of better terms, by some guards who kind of thought he was funny.
Okay.
And Grot and Grop have effectively been leading our merry band of heroes here in the Bannermains toward what sounded to be a shipwreck, where they needed help fighting the Bad Greens. Now, along the way, Cher and Doot, you guys would definitely pass what seems to be a very sheltered little stash of fireworks over here, with a notable on the map where a notable thing is. I'm gonna kind of retrace the steps so it refreshes the fog of war, so you guys get like an understanding of where you guys are in terms of the map. All right, that should have cleared up some fog of war for you.
We've journeyed far and wide.
Yes, yes.
Okay, wait, let me see here. Because I have to play in a virtual machine because I can't trust Meanly.
Oh, yeah?
Cannot, like, eat up all my RAM. Or not a virtual machine, a completely separate computer. Okay, so now we're... Wait, what happened to the festival?
The festival?
We came all the way back!
We made sure the festival wasn't going to explode, so we decided to leave it because we have an actual job to do. That plus
they wanted to leave.
Our main stitch was getting more pissed by the day.
I think it would have been fine.
It probably would have been, but it was a waste of time.
We're not even in the same direction we were originally planning to go.
That's because
we have found Aetherstone.
Yes. That's the whole point of us.
Because
Meanly
felt pity on you guys.
That's what you think, man. It's your adventure, not mine.
Nah, we made the Aetherstone exist by sheer force of will. That's what Meanly's saying.
The goblin says he knows where this Aetherstone is. It's being held by the Bad Greens, which are the Kelpies. We managed to spot one Kelpie, and then the following night, I captured one. We came over, we killed it, and around its neck was a necklace that had an Aetherstone on it. So we believe the Kelpies are holding onto a hoard of Aetherstone. And as soon as we find the shipwreck, we're going to commit genocide, take the Aetherstone, and come back to our boss and be like, hey, boss, look, we did the thing you told us to do. Aren't we great?
We'll be visibly happy at the genocide.
All right, so you are all caught up.
Sounds pretty good.
Okay, well, I guess we're abandoning the party. I'm disappointed in all of you, but I expected nothing.
Well, you never know. We might make it back before the end.
We already have one Aetherstone. Why don't we bring this back?
Because we need more. It
is a tiny necklace-sized, like, pendant rock of Aetherstone. It is not a, like, substantial amount by any means.
You might suspect us of just going to a store and buying it.
It's akin to going to, like, any Colorado... like a river store and seeing those gold flecked little bottle things and saying, "Ooh, look, let me see it. It's real gold, guys." I'm not sure if they have those in the states that you're at, but that's like the most touristy trap thing in Colorado.
Wait, is it not Aetherstone?
Oh no, the thing is Aetherstone. You guys determine that.
Oh, okay.
It's just a little bit of it though. It's like I would say about a thumbnail size. In terms of like,
right, those Meanly with his micro fetish.
Micro.
anything below 1 inch is now micro.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's not literally microscopic.
That's pretty small.
All right.
So where are we?
Well, you guys are waking up as Cher had joined your camp overnight. Said their highs and then slept because it was a long walk with Doot, of all people, who decided that honking the entire way might have been a good way to make friends with Cher, I would assume.
Doot.
Well, I believe if they arrived shortly after we got our gabo, yes, hello, Doot, that was during third shift, so there's maybe 2 extra hours left of sleep before we get up and move normally.
Hmm. And your hellos have been said and caught up, and everybody is now well in the know. Look at that. Yay!
Cher, I thought you were staying for the festivities.
Cher seems to be...
Hang on, I'm still froggy, alright? Look up. I don't drink coffee, but don't talk to me until I have my coffee, okay?
I'm drinking coffee. Oh, wait.
Well, Cher, I would have had breakfast ready for you, but the Gobos ate all of our food, so we're eating trail rations until I can catch something else. Oh, speaking of which, I'm going to go check my traps. Did I catch anything?
You go to check your traps, and in fact, do not find anything. More curiously, however, you do find that your good friend, Grot, is no longer with you. However, Grop seems to be sleeping like a little baby.
I take the chance. Is this the chance I'm gonna put the leash on him?
The NPC?
No. We don't need the leash.
We don't need the leash.
Alright, give me a stealth roll.
Oh my god. I'm disappointed but not surprised by any means.
Tangent and character is going to be making coffee as well. Strong black coffee.
Oh, boy,
really emphasize
okay.
That black part.
Let's see here. What is a? I have to give him a fair perception here. Oh boy, he does not wake up as you pull out your leash and you start clipping it. Clip. However, I don't think your party members are equally as impressed by the fact that you start looking like you are going to clip a leash on Mr. Grob. You guys certainly notice this.
Was Paulo out of session?
Disconnected for some reason.
Did he miss one?
I wasn't in one because Mimi said I couldn't be here.
Oh.
What?
Mimi said, no, Paulo, you're too Brazilian to be with us.
Did I?
Yeah.
I
heard him.
Too Brazilian?
Yeah. That's what Mimi said.
Paulo was European, to be honest.
Yeah, Filipino.
Tangent says, hey, Putin, you know that he's here voluntarily now, right?
She promptly ignores you and leashes him.
Putin, stop leashing the goblin.
I give the ringed one to collar. Now he has a leash on him, and you can guide him as you wish.
Unleash him.
Well, I guess you have the collar.
She scratches her chin, and then she has a great idea. Is there any tree nearby?
I'm going to put away the leash.
I'm keeping it.
Wait, are you gonna lynch the goblin?
No.
Wait, what do you mean?
The leash is in my bag of holding now.
Do not lynch the goblin.
It's colored, but you have the guide part.
I can't understand you over all that dooting.
I'm explaining character. What you see. You see him leash, and you receive the part where you used to guide people with the leash.
I tell Dude, we shouldn't be putting goblins who are willingly working with us in leashes.
And you give Dude
and then I put the leash away.
Tangent says, hey, the coffee's ready.
And the goblin wakes up as you shout this. And he feels...
Does anyone have translate?
You have put away the leash, but he kind of still feels at his neck because he still has a collar on. And then he sees Dude, and he squints. He points accusingly.
She nods.
He takes out a small dagger and starts trying to cut it off. It is just leather. and they promptly cut through the leather of the collar, and it falls off. They see it fall. They look down. They pick it up. And they start swinging it around.
Crosswalk! Crosswalk! Crosswalk!
I do.
They chuck it at you. Thump.
I do it.
Sharon's glad she gave up being in the city to come out to this. This is...
The goblin promptly, like, looks over, kind of, you see the goblin's nose kind of twitching, twitch, 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 and they blink. They look toward the coffee. And they run toward the coffee, likely over Cher, who is probably still waking up. Cher, you get a rude awakening by a gobbo.
Awakening, of course. That's why I'm so glad to find that in this small span of time that I leave you guys alone, you not only add one non-pony creature, but two goblins. Great. I believe I'm the only pony now in the world that is supposed to be owned by ponies.
Goswanazar!
He points to you, Cher.
Zagosar!
You're in agreement.
Don't agree with it.
You only encourage it. Don't agree. Don't acknowledge it.
The little gobbo looks at the coffee pot, promptly pulls out a small little drum that seems to have been hand or hoof made rather, and starts beating on it. Thum 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 thum. It doesn't really have a rhythm, but they're doing their best.
It's like having a child, like a young child in the party.
Well, we used to have a translator, but
I don't. I have commons being draconic and sylvan. I don't see anything about language.
Be in your spells.
What's going on?
Comprehend languages. It's a first level.
Do I have to do comprehend languages for this, really?
You might have to, because I don't. Yeah, I don't.
What are you trying to say?
Well, I don't know. You have to tell us.
Oh, fine. DM, I cast Comprehend Languages.
Do you?
While sipping my cup of coffee.
Alright, you start casting Comprehend Languages as this goblin is saying things and beating the drum and pointing at Cher. And as you do, you start hearing them talk.
Dumzog! Dumzog!
And pointing toward Cher.
Lizzazog!
I still can't understand you. Thumbzog?
He seems to be saying Dumbzog. I'm pointing at Cher.
Is that like a name what? I recognize?
No.
Zog.
Just seems to be calling Cher a Dumbzog.
Dumbzog.
So it's like a goblin insult? I wasted a spell for this?
Cher feels that this is somehow racist, and Sarah does not approve.
Can I make a roll for this in some way?
Headlock club, pick a gog!
And he starts like beating the drum. Thum, 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 thum.
Can I make a roll for what it might be?
I mean,
Rat, this is your fault. I hope you know. This is all your fault.
You're welcome to try to give me a linguistics. I'm not gonna stop you.
I don't have it trained.
Then the max you could roll is 10.
I'm gonna take 10.
You can't take 10.
Why not?
Because he said the word a couple times, and it's definitely not something you're taking your time to try to decide. Your roll, however, would get you that it's probably an insult. Probably. You're not really sure. It's not something you've heard before.
I'm going to choose to just not share that with Cher.
I'm pretty sure Cher has a feeling that the pointing and screeching of certain words over and over while pointing at Cher is probably an insult.
What? Tangent turns to Cher and goes, what is this problem with you? What'd you do?
Kelp is green, but the screen bads smashed their hands and ripped their guards, guarding something very good. Gobbles, take it. Yes, they should.
And he starts beating the drum more.
He's singing.
Wait.
He's singing a war song. Guys.
He's winning a drum. Did you
make this beforehand? You just have a bunch of rhymes, namely.
Maliminous, let me tell you, I play bards. like.
I'm gonna sing with him a war song.
You do. What is this war song that you sing?
I do it, but they kind of do it to her when the villain shows up in the movie.
An
evil dude.
Is it just like the Inception blah, but just with duding?
I haven't watched that movie.
No one's watched Inception. We just know the memes about Inception. The parodies of Inception
But what does that have to do with what we're doing right now?
He's doing a menacing dude. So like the blah.
Oh, okay.
Those of you guys watching, he looks at the coffee pot and he looks in. You guys from the outside kind of hear, "What's up, what's whatever?" You, Tangent, get, what is this? Is this Warboss's drink? Warboss drink blood! Yes, yes, blood! Blood of the Crimson Green Ones! And he starts, like, dancing.
Can't explain to him it's not blood.
You can't explain to him, no.
No, I'll pour him a cup of coffee.
And he looks at the coffee.
Oh, no, that's probably not a good idea.
He takes the coffee. And he smiles. Yes, yes, bathe in the blood of the helping! Pours it over his head. Ah! And starts running around in circles.
Oh, no.
He starts running around in circles. Well, from the outside, you guys just hear, Blaswa!
Tangent, Moon Planner, how do I bathe the goblin? Do I just hose him down?
How close are we to the water?
You guys are pretty close to the water.
Oh,
Moon Planter
look,
is...
guys, Grot's coming back.
Okay.
No hunting.
Tangent pours out her coffee out of her cup, gets a cup of water instead, and splashes the goblin.
Grot.
Didn't it start at 7? Am I late?
Seven Eastern.
Seven Eastern.
Oh, Eastern! Oh, shit!
it's perfectly fine. We pretty much just started for the most part. What you come back to, and you know, Grot might not have been there at the very start.
Time zones are a thing.
Oh, you're good. You're good. Coming back, however, Grot, you are met with the sight of what seems to be the sight of Grop. Who is getting water splashed on him, seemingly with coffee all over his head. You guys in the party see Grot coming back with a couple of squirrels and general hunting things.
Is this very important? As soon as they throw water on the goblin to make him not burn anymore, I'm gonna throw my coffee on the goblin.
You can't just assault the goblin.
I'm gonna try and stop the dude from pouring coffee on the goblin.
I feel like that would probably be a CM.
Assist him with avoiding the coffee.
That would be a CMB check to disarm him of the coffee.
Okay. Watch me not disarm him. Oh hey, they updated the character sheets again. It's kind of nice.
where are you? Like you came back pretty much out of the little bushels of forest and you know things like searching for this. Where are you coming to Grot? Like you're seeing all this go down and then what do you do?
So you guys see her with like squirrel tails and like badger heads sticking out of her cloak, and there's just blood all over the fucking place. Like, she gored these things. And she's coming back cautiously and, like, very defensively over the food she just found.
And Moonplanter sees you coming back with squirrels, and he says, "Oh, there you are. I thought you had run off. Nice haul. How many squirrels did you catch?"
Mine.
You caught 9 squirrels?
Mine.
Saying mine.
Oh, mine. No, you know what? Considering that you ate all of my squirrels and the stew that I made, those are actually mine. So I'll take them and cook them up later.
Mine.
Don't you hiss at me. I have a pocket I can put you in.
She like flinches at that.
The goblin now with coffee on his head that seems to have recovered from pouring coffee on their head kind of shakes their head, looks to Grot, and points at Grot and says, Tangent, who you had cast comprehend language, and Grot, you both hear him say, "Greedy Grot, Greedy Grot."
Greedy what?
Guts.
Greedy Grot. Grot.
Oh, okay. I say Greedy Grot is what you're saying.
Greedy about what?
You don't Grot understand
hisses
that.
It, Grop. Yeah. Mine.
And then he squints.
Moonplanter will fly over to Grot and hold his hoof out to take the squirrels. I'll take those.
Your Grot flinches and then curls up on the ground. Mine!
Moonplanter takes out his staff and starts swinging it around by the lanyard. "You ate everyone's food yesterday. You and that other little shrimp that travels with you. Give me the squirrel so I have enough food to cook for everyone."
Tangent says,
just
"Hey,
looks petrified at the stick.
This isn't very fair.
The,
stop trying to steal her squirrels."
Yeah, Grot, who sees the stick start flying around, suddenly gets all mad. And Tangent, you see him take his cup and dip it in the cup of coffee, and start running at Moonplanter.
You do have coffee, not blood, right? Tangent says, even knowing that Crump Kitten can't understand her.
Splash.
It's not that hot, by the way.
It's hot. I mean, if it's good coffee, it's not pleasant.
Now your clothes are stained.
You get a splash with an unpleasantly hot cup of coffee.
All over the armor.
Splash!
Alright, he's going to get hit with a sap. And, in fact, I'm going to Dirty Trick Grot. Grop or Grub. I'm going to call him Grub. So let's see. Yeah, it'd just be this right here. Alright, I'm going to swing the sap by the lanyard and smack him in the balls just like last time.
Will you?
Yes.
All right,
to make
shot
it
going on.
Let's double check that. All right, where's his combat? There it is. They changed up the sheet just a little bit, so I gotta figure out where they put everything again. Against his CMD. Wait, you're just striking him normally, right? You miss. Whoosh. And he kind of he jumps over your he jumps to the side and looks up to you a little bit angry, like.
And, you're just as guilty as eating all of my food yesterday as well. This is just as much your fault. Don't you take that tone of voice with me. Oh, that's it, you little shit. Come here.
Children, stop fighting.
While take his back is turned at me, I'm going to bite his ankle. Oh, I missed.
Dude,
I chew on his armor then.
Yeah.
I'm inspire competence, so everyone hits each other better.
Tangent is gonna take the coffee pot and hide it from the goblins.
Hang on, are you biting my ankle or taking a coffee pot?
Huh? No, that was the tangent.
Oh, that was the other internet female. Sorry.
You yeah.
They don't all sound the same. I know they all... Wow. Rude.
Yeah, they do.
They do.
But you're getting your ankles lightly bit. Your armor is kind of saving you from gobbo teeth at the moment. But there is definitely an effort.
All right. Well, I'm going to dirty trick another one. I'm going to use the sap to stun Grub. And are we paused? Because I can't post an attack. Yeah, we are paused.
You should be able to post an attack regardless.
Refresh.
Yep,
F5.
F5 is going to be your friend with these with this new update as they kind of patch out some bugs.
I do like the way they made the character sheets look.
Mm-hmm. It is pretty
well,
good.
Well, oh, I haven't seen. Have they changed them? Let me take
yeah,
a look.
Yeah, they added some new boxes that look nice.
Okay, wait, how do I do that again? Okay.
It's in the group of people.
No.
Uh-huh, and then it's gaming. PC. No, gaming, because right. We're Epic Gamers.
Yeah.
The Inspired Courage, is that a +2 or a +1?
That's pretty good.
Is that a +1 or a +2?
+1.
It is +1 at your level, yeah.
This is the joys of a mixing palette.
Yeah, yeah.
This is what Shadow has been warning you about all this time. No one listens to Shadow.
Grot, as you are biting the ankles of your fellow Bannermane here, you do notice out of the corner of your eye there seems to be two others that you've seen before you joined. One with a big Russian style cap. And a Kieran who seems to have a small trumpet.
Grot is gonna let go of the ankle and hide behind. Just hide under Nightglider's wing.
Nightgliders?
Yeah.
Who's that?
Yeah.
Oh wait, did I get the name wrong? I'm really bad with memorizing names.
Yeah, you're good. You're good. Moon Planter is the one.
Moon
that you're
Planter.
Biting. Yeah, yeah.
Right. I let go of his ankle and hide under his wing when I notice the other two.
Grop.
Yeah, you're.
Grop to this keeps his growling up.
Yeah, you, you did not hit well enough to get through my armor, so it didn't even register. So I'm just focusing on Grub right now. So I did another dirty trick. Did I beat his CMD?
You did.
Alright, he gets a staggered condition. Did I beat it by 5 or more? He gets it for an extra round.
You did not.
Alright, he is staggered for 1 round.
Which, people who have, comprehend languages or understand the language hear a very loud and long slur of goblin curses.
Still working?
Grot, can you please ask Grob to stop? Or Grop.
It says 10 minutes per level, so I get 30 minutes. That sounds like a good long time to me.
Yeah.
If you stay away from my squirrels.
Planter,
are you
please
that
just
while...
let them have their squirrels.
Are you saying that while hiding under my wing?
Yes.
I'm going to take your squirrels.
Oh no.
She hides further in your wing. No, my squirrels.
I'm going to wrap my wing tightly around you so you're pinned against my body, and I'm going to take your squirrels anyway.
Aren't they?
Okay, your squirrels! Your squirrels!
Alright.
She, like, pulls dead animals out of her robes, and some of them are, like, half-eaten. Faces chewed up. Tails pulled off.
Moonplanter is looking at these very dissatisfied. I'm going to make a survival check to determine if any of these are safe for eating.
Maybe the ones that aren't bitten.
How many are not bitten?
Grot, give me a 1d4.
Yeah. Oh wait, this isn't roll 20. Wait, does the double bracket work in Foundry?
It's not double. I'm not sure if the double bracket does. I just know slash roll 1d, 1d whatever is. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, whoops.
I could reveal it. Don't worry. The And you look at the squirrels, and it seems like two of them are probably better for eating than the other two.
One of them is still breathing.
Oh, God.
That's actually good. Fresh meat's good. All right, so looking at the mangled corpses of most of the squirrels, Moonplanter will open his wing and let you go kerplop to the ground. And he's going to toss seven of the squirrels aside, keeping two of them. The one that's still alive, he'll just grab it by the neck and he'll... and put it into his bag of holding.
The goblin's gonna immediately put them back in her pockets.
And he points his wing at you like a thumb. It's like, don't ever steal my food again.
Wait, do you point with your thumb?
Yeah, because bad wings have thumbs.
Weird.
And
your species is weird.
The goblin just glares back at you.
He squints at you, and then yeah, as well, and looks toward a Warboss. Warboss, what's wrong? And he kind of rolls his eyes. Those who can understand heard him rather say, "All orcs are equal, but some orcs are more equal than others." And he sees.
Tien just says, "Krupp, come here, Krupp." Does it come here?
Well, you can't speak goblin, but you could understand it. And so he just tilts his head.
Oh, he can't speak common?
Grop, no.
Oh.
Yeah, no.
Goblinos, they can't
Tangent
speak the large
tongue. Tangent will turn to Grot and say, Grot, can you tell him to come here? I've got a job for him.
No. She is dead.
And Grot says some things, he turns, and he looks that way, toward you, Tangent. He squints, and you see him kind of lower to the ground. And he picks up a rock and he just slowly starts walking over. He looks very, very suspicious.
Graf says, "Do you want to help me find bird eggs? I know where there's a nest, and I want breakfast."
And he looks to Grot for the translation of this. And his eyes go big.
Orby!
And he smiles.
Or you can have it all to yourself.
Summer!
Yes, okay. I hope your climbing skill is good. Mine's not, and that's why I need help.
Why are you babying the goblinos?
He starts sniffing around, seemingly looking for something that he seems to be calling the Orby.
I still have comprehend language.
Yeah, yeah.
What's an Orby?
He just seems to be saying Orby, whether or not you have comprehend languages or not. He seems to register that as a...
he makes up words. This makes things so much harder.
He seems to be sniffing around, sniff, 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 and he's going over towards Cher, sniff, 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 and then looks up towards Cher's big hat, and he squints.
And just going to still be trying to get Grub to follow her to a tree that has a nest... A nest in it.
You can give me a diplomacy roll for that one.
Sure. You're gonna use diplomacy. Do they think my hat is not a nest? my hat is a wonderful piece of the people's ingenuity.
He seems to be weighing his options, looking between where you're gesturing to a tree and the big nest upon Cher's head.
I'm going to... Wait, there's a nest on Cher's head?
Oh, yes, there
it's
is.
It's not a nest! It is a beautiful hat.
And he seems to squint, and he gives you the look before going off toward Tangent to help them find some bird eggs. Which, in the couple trees that are around, yes, there'd be a couple.
We're going to try and climb those trees, so...
Are you climbing them themselves, or are you asking Grop to climb them?
I'm asking Grop to climb them because I'm sure that he can climb better than I can.
How are you doing such
that's
things?
That's a good question. Shit. Grot.
Around.
Grot, I need you to tell Grump to climb the trees, please.
What's in it for me?
Do you like coffee? Oh, do you want to burn it?
Scuffle even had coffee before. I'm gonna roll a wisdom check, and if I get over 10, then I've had coffee before.
Okay.
Fair.
Shit, there's my attributes.
I guess you love coffee.
Tangent just gives her coffee.
Climb tree.
I'm going to regret this in about 20 minutes.
Grop looks up and starts up into the tree toward a couple nests that he sees, and he starts looking in them. And he holds up two eggs. Ta-da!
Cool. Now, you can either eat it. Do goblins eat eggs raw? Would I know that? I bet they do.
Goblins cook their eggs?
He seems to be holding them, and he puts two of them in one hand, and then he starts rummaging in one of the other nests. Rummage. Aha! And he finds that one. And he seems to have a total of about four eggs. And don't mind me. And he keeps looking around, looking.
Oh, shit.
And then you see him start to go deeper into some of the leaves, and you're free to give me a perception check, but he seems to have spotted something.
Okay. Let me find my perception. See, my climb is actually a -5, so don't ask me how or why.
Yeah, I don't know how a cat got that bad at climbing.
You see...
Places?
Grop with his little grubby hooves starting to reach for something deeper in there that seems to be more built onto the tree. It does not seem like a bird nest by any point. As he gets closer to it, you start to hear a small buzzing. Buzz.
Oh no.
Why?
Oh well, he's gonna find out real quick. Is there anything I can cast to help him out, maybe?
It's your adventure, not mine.
Alright, give me that. Wait, I have an
magic
idea.
Wait, no. You gonna cast spark to agitate them more?
Smoke actually causes bees to become pacified.
Then cast smoke, not spark.
I don't have smoke.
Anyone here vape?
That raises a hoof.
Can we
smoke with the prestidigitation?
Make a conjure a small little bit of smoke with prestidigitation. I'd say that's good. Oh, prestidigitation, okay. Otherwise known as minor wish. So pretty much, yeah. Small bit of smoke, though. Has to be within a 5-foot range, I believe, the range of prestidigitation is, though.
Tall as that tree.
But he does seem to be reaching toward this. And don't
you know
mind...
what? I think we're just gonna have to let this happen. And I'll go, Rah! No! Those are bees!
Give me your best diplomacy roll.
Grop, I believe in you.
You shout, and for a half second just before he's about to touch it, he stops and he blinks. And then he kind of tilts his head a little bit, and you see his ears flicker. And he hears the buzzing. Bzzz! Bzzz!
That's right, don't touch the bees. Doesn't he know what a bee is?
And he looks down. To you, Grot. Bzzz!
Bees, honey!
No, honey!
No.
See him lightly lick his lips. Well, and he kind of looks up toward Warboss. Warboss! Warboss!
Tell them no bees.
Warboss.
Ven, are you there? Oh no.
He went BRB.
Oh, he did go BRB in the moment that we needed Warboss most.
We needed to go to the bathroom, though.
Well, he seems to be considering. He's licking his lips. And he looks down at the eggs.
Orbis will buzz!
Down here, then you can go sacrifice yourself for some bees. I don't care.
And he seems, this is where I make a roll. For, Yeah. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. They changed up the sheet. Let me find this again. There it is.
These are some fucking electric shit bees, just like in Pony.
And he looks down to you, Grot, and he gestures for you to come below the branch that he's on.
Grot does so.
And he in Goblin just says, "Catch!" and starts dropping down the eggs.
I'll try to catch the eggs. Do I have to make a dex roll or something?
Reflex save. DC of 10. It's not hard to catch something you are fully aware of.
Okay. Shit, where is it?
It'll be in, they changed it on the sheet here.
Yeah, there's combat. No longer a defense. Combat, okay.
Yep.
There it is.
You catch one of them. And there's three more coming your way.
Oh, roll three more?
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Oh. One gets in her face and she just looks it up. Oh, two of them.
Well, one
so
hit...
I catch two of them with both hands and then realize I have no other hands to catch the other two. I catch it with my face.
He gives a small shrug, such a small price to pay for, you know, such delicious eggs. And looking back up to the nest, he looks toward you, War Boss.
War Boss!
Are the eggs intact or not?
No, two of them are.
Two of them are.
No. Dayspring looks up.
And yeah. He points to the beehive that is up in the tree.
Hmm. Well, don't have any smoke, so Dayspring's gonna, like, shake her head no.
He looks very disappointed.
Hey, do we still have a lit fire?
Yeah, we should.
I assumed that you guys put those out every morning, but
I mean, well, I was cooking the coffee pot over.
Oh, this is true.
Yeah, we haven't fully left our campsite yet.
I don't think
that's maybe
anything,
smoke the
though.
Beehive.
I'm pretty sure it takes, like, concentrated puffs of smoke to get them to be docile. I've never seen it just be, like, normal smoke. Just
it could,
like,
be normal smoke.
Yeah, you could use normal smoke. You just need a lot of it.
Yeah, you just need, like, a whole burning branch and just hold it under the thing for, like, 5 seconds.
Wait, then spark would work.
There's a video of a guy doing that, and he's wearing, like, dead animal skin that he hasn't tanned. He just took it off roadkill, and it's fucking great.
I, too, get all my survival videos from survival knowledge from YouTube.
Hell yeah, man. Andrew Uckles is fucking great.
Oh, man. He seems to, be pondering. War Boss said no. These things are buzzing. Nope. And he looks towards you, Dute. And he jumps off the tree towards you and just says, "Pasma!" Which in Goblin translates for you two who can understand to "catch me." And you're free to catch him.
Nice. Is he jumping on me?
He is.
No, he's jumping on me. This is a very important decision.
You're gonna move out of the way, aren't you?
I'm gonna catch him, but as I catch him, I use the memento to throw him home to campfire.
Why? Why are you so homicidal?
Well, it is,
What is his alignment?
We have a backstory for him now.
You are free to give me a reflex save to do the catch first.
And there's nothing we can do about this.
I mean physics is a mean mistress.
Can you even imagine what's going through
I could imagine what's going through his head. There we go. You do catch him and, you know, freely grapple because he kind of landed into the grapple. Yay! You have him.
I used the moment to draw him with the fire.
You're welcome to give me a strength test.
What? Oh, no, I'm using the momentum, not using my strength.
All that momentum's down.
No,
you can't just flip that.
Change the vector of momentum.
Yeah. It takes work to change that.
It actually takes more work.
You catch and try to very promptly switch directions, but only just gently kind of set him on the ground in an awkward way. God. And you lift him up just a little bit, and he kind of, like, his toes kind of wiggle, and he kind of wriggles out of your grasp. What's wrong? You get booped.
You got a 3.
He kind of,
glad the rest of the party doesn't know what you just tried to do.
They can't know.
He rushes over to Grot, who has 2 of the eggs, and he,
I pass him one.
He smiles and he holds it up.
Oh, sorry!
So what's happening with the bees?
Well, the bee, he abandoned the bees, so we're good.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now he is looking at his egg, and he looks at it. He looks at it incredibly deeply. Then he looks at Cher's big hat.
Oh my god.
I try and climb the other tree with the eggs. How badly did I do?
That should answer your question.
Oh. Well, I don't climb that tree with the eggs. No, do I?
I don't know why you try to climb anything with a -5.
Yeah, I know. I was hoping maybe I'd roll high.
Were you declawed when you were a child? What happened?
Yeah. The backstory.
The sun cats just have negatives to climbing. I don't know why. Maybe because they live in a really flat place. The desert. That's what I'm going with.
That's true. Okay. I mean, it's very. There's not a lot of trees to climb in the desert.
Yeah, cactus.
I don't think you climb cactuses. And I don't think they grow that tall.
You might have a hard time climbing a cactus.
Anything's a tree if you're brave enough.
Anything's a tree as long as you're brave enough.
Negative to swim as well. What the hell?
Well, you do live
you're
in the
a
desert.
Cat.
Ah, yes.
And they're a cat. You have +1 to consumption of lasagnas, -3 to Mondays, though. It is the way of things.
Well, eggs begotten and everything like that, the morning generally goes fairly well from there. However, Grop wants to pull everybody together, and through a mix of collaboration between likely Grot and Tangent, who can understand him for a brief time, he seems to wish to want to plan the next invasion with Warboss.
Yes, Warboss!
Warboss!
Julius is gonna pick up a mug.
If spring comes over.
Tim says, don't worry, we'll be going after those Kelpies soon enough, and then looks at Grot to translate that.
She's gonna point at the mug and then to herself and put the mug on the middle.
I don't know what they mean by this.
Because it's
do
okay.
You
it's
wish my... you were a mug?
People will get.
Yeah, you see, be let's big? See if I can work this out.
Do you want more coffee?
Coffee.
Shake head.
I
cannot see.
Hey,
I don't know what the DC with this to be, because me as a DM.
Oh yeah, I guess
understand.
Paladin. Yeah.
Jim, do you know when you make a great plan and you put small soldiers on the map to indicate people? She's the mug.
What?
Mug.
What?
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 I said it last time movie. I'm very disappointed in the wall.
Brack, can you translate?
Character Palo is saying that the mug is their token.
Yeah.
Token.
If you're playing Monopoly, they're the
Wait. Mug. So in game you have a token in game.
You know, it's very difficult to produce a strategy, especially with a map, if we have no idea what the enemy's layout is.
Grop kind of points to it and snickers, looking over to Grot and just says, dump.
Emily, reveal the roll so Paolo can tell me if I won.
Dump!
DC5, everyone shall get it.
So you are making like a...
Don't worry.
Can we use Don't my worry. Language on the map?
What was that?
Can we use highlighters on the map? Then we can just highlight the areas of interest.
Where do you get a highlighter?
I think those do don't necessarily exist.
Fine, can we use bits of charcoal?
I have charcoal and chalk.
We also have a campfire.
Look at that.
Putting the map on the campfire?
No.
I mean, at the very least, we could just continue traveling north because we're getting closer to some kind of shipwreck. There's more evidence for it. So if we were to just, you know, move out, we're likely to find something. And if we're quiet, we can figure out where the Kelpies are, and then we can plan from there.
Well, does Grop know anything about the shipwreck he, like, wants to tell us? Because he's the one who called this... meeting.
And he smiles and starts with gentle encouragement, I take it, would start talking.
What is he saying?
He says in a goblin tongue, well, your comprehend languages only lasts how long? Just curious.
Minutes.
It's probably been a little bit longer than that.
Oh, okay.
But I will still say things. Let's see, in here, because he's kind of relying on Grot to translate.
Grot.
Oh, but it's in English. You must stop.
Oh.
It's okay.
Actually, I could just drag in a token over here onto this map so I don't have to keep switching. How about that? Give me a second. I got an F5 around. Actually, I could just do this.
When you F5, it doesn't reload for us, too?
No.
Huh.
At least I would hope not. Let's see.
Is the game paused for anyone?
What was it that? Aha, there we go.
Is the game paused for anyone else?
Yeah, it's paused.
Okay. Just making
pause.
Sure. The game has been paused.
I can't believe it. We're pausing the
Damn,
game.
Damn, it really did be like that.
Alright.
Pop up this time.
Yes. War bus.
Alright, now what's it say?
Yeah?
War bus goes first. War bus lead charge. War bus stomp bad greens.
No, it's not.
Okay.
Yes, that's the plan, so that's what we'll go for.
You know
for,
anything
right?
about the Bad Greens' hideout?
Cave. And... bad.
Not.
Many, you know many goblins died to war. Long war.
Do you know how many Kelpies there are?
Do I know how many Kelpies there are, Mimli?
You know that there's, there's enough to rival your clan.
Okay, so Grot puts out two of her, hooves in front of you guys and says, this much.
Yes. Okay,
100 boys.
100. Okay. Do you know if there's an... Is there an exit to the cave, or is it just, like, cut into the seawall?
Don't know.
Oh, shit. Is the cave underwater?
Goblins don't go that far.
I don't think the goblins are sea creatures, so I don't assume the cave is underwater.
I don't know inside of cave. No, only no entrance.
Is it a big open cave or a tight cave?
Do I know this, Weebly?
You know that the cave in question that has been told is likely where these kelpies come from is definitely in a place not many gobos can get. Definitely underwater, and kind of
wait.
Far,
so it is underwater.
Kind
the
of
cave
far
itself?
Out into the kind of far out into the depths itself.
Maybe need it's a cave. Many water.
Okay.
Okay, what kind of weapons do the bad ones have?
They're not gonna know that.
Oh, they might.
Yeah.
They bite.
They bite, okay. Namely, the Kelpie that we trapped earlier today, did it have weapons on it?
That one did not, but it did seem to have very sharp hooves.
Okay, so probably natural attacks.
They stomp.
Are we packing things up? I'm gonna start packing things up if it looks like they're gonna be traveling soon.
I'm assuming that you guys are doing that while this is happening.
Moon
got most of this packed up while shenanigans were going on.
Cher has to ask. Well, Cher is all for a race war. Why are we diving headfirst into a goblin cave that we don't know even has an exit? To fight off 100 goblins.
Warbucks.
Actually, they're kelpie.
Are you kelpies? Same as the genetic property.
Warbucks want rock.
Found that one of them had an Aether Stone necklace, and that there was a recent shipwreck, which might have been carrying a load of Aether Stone.
You care to translate?
I typed that in chat for you.
Wait, which chat?
He's typing it in Gabo so we can't read it.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean in the game chat?
Yep, yep.
Hi. Their treasure belongs to green ones. To Warboss.
Alright, so these kelpies likely have what we need, so that's why we're going into the caves.
And we're calling in no reinforcements for the 6 of us or so, 3 of which are useless, go and fight all 100?
Warbucks want more boys. We can get more boys.
Really? How many more boys?
Fedney's very close by. Warbucks can get more boys and we stomp them.
That might be a good idea.
Wait, are we going to have to stomp them to get them to join us?
I'm not Warboss sure if we can Warboss. Actually get them to join us.
Wherever you go, join Warboss.
And yeah, he nods vehemently to this. And speaks once again his goblin tongue.
That might actually work. Why don't we get a bunch of goblins to act as cannon fodder, and then we'll sneak in, grab the Aether Stone, and leave.
Yes, using inferior races as human shields. Cher's favorite.
I want to impress upon everybody that the ceremony is in 5 days.
Yeah, but that's not important. We have other stuff going on.
It is important. There's a reason he keeps ranking it up. It's a side quest.
We were given a very specific job. I tell you what, let's go get us some goblins. If we hurry, we just might make it back in time and have Aetherstone to go with it.
Also, I'm only bringing it up because he has the goblin does kind of repeatedly keep bringing up things.
Revolution.
Yeah, yeah.
Now we could lead them to revolution against the bad green menace.
I think we can handle the shipwreck. Let's focus on finding the shipwreck and deal with what comes.
Well, if the shipwreck is going to be right by a Kelpie infestation, we need to be ready to fight for them. If we can have a bunch of goblins fight them for us, it'll make our job a lot easier.
Makes you think the goblins would willingly sacrifice themselves for our benefit.
Because we have the Ringed One.
We have the War Boss.
Is
there a goblin settlement nearby on our way?
Yeah.
Not on the way, but close.
Okay.
How close?
How close?
Mark on the map.
Yeah, I was gonna say, let's pull up and have show.
Show and tell.
You are given a map. Now, Grodd, do you understand reading maps?
I try to eat the paper as soon as you show it to me, especially if there's letters on it.
If you don't get that out of your mouth, I'm gonna box your ears. This is for looking, not eating.
Bad paper.
This is war paper. We use this for war.
Paper, take mind.
And Grop also hisses.
Okay, they're not gonna be able to use the map.
Yeah.
All right. How many days will it take us to go find the other goblins?
You can, if you have it trained, you could certainly give me a knowledge geography for that, Grot.
Let's see. I doubt I do, but I will see.
I'm very good at geography, I just have no idea where these things are.
Have it trained.
I do not have it trained.
Silly Gobbo.
Let me see if, let's see if a friend here has it trained.
More along the coast.
I would think Grot gestures more northernly.
Yeah.
Will we find evidence of them before anything else?
Will we find them today?
No.
Will we find them tomorrow?
Maybe if we run.
Grot and 8-Ball.
So we're probably going to have to exhaustive march, and we might find them. But I don't really want to find a group of goblins while exhausted.
Yeah, I want to go the normal pace.
It's okay, they invited us that one time.
One worst that can happen.
I can think of plenty.
Alright, well I think it's a good idea to get an army of goblins on our side. So let's go get the goblins. And then we'll go to the Kelpies, gather all the Aetherstone, and make it back in time for the ceremony.
Probably won't make it back in time.
We'll make it back in time for the ceremony.
Pretty sure we won't.
That's just how talented we are.
Yeah.
We are talented and attractive banner mains, and we accomplish everything we set our minds to because we are good.
All right, Sam. So how's this work?
I'll show you guys in comparison to the map that you have here in... TTRPG voice. Actually, give me a knowledge geography before I give you this. How about that?
Who's got the best one?
You want me? I can roll mine anyway.
Actually, does anyone have a compass?
Oh wait, I'm not trained in it. Never mind.
Who's got a compass? I have a compass.
Did anyone buy a compass? Yeah, there you go. Yeah. You have a compass.
You get a +2 to avoid becoming lost. You could also use that. I'll give you that +2 on this geography one, just for this specific role. Moonplanter, if you look at TTRPG voice, I'll kind of put this. This is the general amount of hexes you're looking at in terms of how far you are away from the capital.
Okay, so we're several days out, and we're gonna have to go through a deep portion of the woods, but we can still make it if we take a straight shot.
We could force march.
To the festival, home, I guess.
Yeah, it's just the festival.
You guys can at max a day go 4 hexes if you do not sleep.
Okay.
But that's very dangerous. Alright.
I want to continue going up the coast.
As long as we don't do it too much, we'd be okay.
Well, we need to get to the goblins first, then we need to fight the Kelpies, take the Aetherstone, and then return to the capital.
Well, let's start traveling.
All right, Grub. And I point my thumb into his face. You're going to take us to the Gobbos, and we're going to get them to join the war boss. Can you dig it?
And he looks to Grot for a translation.
Yeah.
We get more boys for war boss.
I tell him in Goblin.
And he thinks. He thinks. And he kind of shakes his head. Shake, shake, shake. And I will type out his response here.
I mean, I understand
what shaking a head means. No, he's not SMH shaking his head.
Let me see. Public roll. There we go.
Okay. He's just vibrating uncontrollably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ew. What the fuck is this? Yeah, war bus. Krupp says boy's not home. Oh. We need to do this alone, but you're strong. You're war bus. You can kill bad greens.
Well, we are going into an unknown territory to fight possibly 100 enemies.
100.
Wait, that Kelpie we killed still nearby, right?
I mean, yeah, you guys killed it. It's not going anywhere anytime soon.
We died to almost 2 or 3 lions that one time.
All right, I did keep its skin. We ripped its skin off, and it's all like jagged and messed up because it wasn't like an entire body.
I need its skull.
Its skull would still be over there.
Okay.
I did take out the skin though, and I look to Grub, and then back at the skin, and then back to me.
So long. Let's
I'm gonna analyze the skull. Wow. I need to double check what it's called. So I link the right one. Phonology.
Oh, okay.
Once per day, you can use a fingertip. Any mustard. Alright, 4 minutes. Helpless trailer.
What is this from?
Alright, hang on. Dice, a single check. Turns. Okay. So you're trying to determine race, age, gender, alignment, class, maybe not level.
My main goal is figuring out its hit dice.
Okay. But so it looks like you have to give me a knowledge arcana?
Yep.
I have a knowledge arcana. Let's see. After a minute is up, the GM attempts a secret knowledge arcana. Modified. Yeah. So give me a blind roll you knowledge arcana. You determine that the let's see here, let me just double check. You determine thusly that the creatures might be pretty feisty. You probably get in the range between 3 and 7.
That's potentially every swing of a weapon is a dead Kelpie.
Wait, between 3 and 7?
Hit dice, if you're looking at hit dice.
Oh, hit dice, no.
That's for that specific creature.
Mm-hmm.
Can I also cast a spell?
Specific creature has a hit die of 3 to 7?
Your reading was unclear, is what I was getting at.
Okay.
What are you going to cast?
I want to cast Strength Deep from Mimir as well. If we're spending time doing auguries.
Well, that's not really an augury, that's a...
It's something a else. Cantrip, maybe?
It's a class feature, but yeah.
Yeah,
if you want to augury-esque go into there, you could. Yeah, although it'll take longer than a day.
Wait, it'll take longer than a day?
Yeah, to get there.
Oh, no, the spell won't take as long as a day.
So the thing, I don't know, well, Mimli, how do you do augury? Because I was, like, reading into it, and I was, like, thinking...
No, it's Strength Deep from Mimir as well, not augury. Is that something I have? Hold on, let me see.
Grop is nudging you again, Grot.
Oh, that is something I have.
Warboss.
Hello.
Help with raid on,
hold on.
Warboss, why need stone now? Maybe get stone after capital. After raid. Big raid.
Kaboom!
Well, the stone is pretty important.
So I wanted to drink deep from here as well, based on if we're gonna find Aether Stone at the shipwreck or not.
Alright, and what does that do again?
You call Wisdom of the Runes of the Sky to provide you with guidance. Roll 1d20 and add your Wisdom bonus to the roll. On a result of 20 or better, DM provides you with obscure but useful advice. On a roll lower than that, it's just something that's largely useless, like be kind to animals.
You get the insight back. Be nice to Grot.
I guess my roll wasn't very good.
Okay, so Grot wants to... Well, Grot and Grop want to go back and do the revolution thing.
There are a couple options on the table. One option is to that have been proposed so far. One is to go up the shore and just head them up yourselves. One is to try to see about dragging some goblins, if any, back out here before going back to the capital. And one that was just proposed by Grot and Grop, which is to do help the gobos with their raid on the capital before getting more boys and coming back here after the fact.
We wouldn't be doing that.
Duty is gonna do it very loudly to get everyone's attention. And then she's gonna put a coin.
You hear her doot very, very loudly.
She picks up the coin. She puts it to one side. She flips the coin.
Wait, which side is which? If we don't know which side is which, then it doesn't matter.
She gives the coin to War Leader.
Warboss?
Warboss. Warboss.
War Leader.
Okay.
A pony of many names. I guess we're deciding literally between treason, 100 man versus 6 man battle by a coin toss? Okay.
Yeah.
Look, if it's a small enough cave entrance, we can just build a fire in front of it and smoke everything out.
Can't build a fire underwater.
The cave entrance is not underwater, though.
Not.
Is the cave entrance underwater, Meemly?
I don't know why you're asking me this.
Okay, Grub, is the cave entrance underwater?
Is what?
Warboss, start fire in water. Warboss, strong.
Grop's eyes go kind of wide. He looks impressed.
Well, we could try to maybe convince the goblins to come help us with the raid on the Kelpies. I mean, after all, they've directly wronged the tribe, it seems, in a lot more severe ways than Bleakburn.
Yeah, Grub, how many goblins are supposed to be taking over the capital?
Mm-hmm. All the boys. And Warboss.
Okay, but how many?
One clan.
How many is in your clan?
A lot.
Okay, if there are two squirrels and your clan is going to kill each other over the two squirrels, how many goblins are going to die before they get to the squirrels?
All but one.
You know what? That makes sense.
Yeah.
We don't know how many gobos there are. Look, at the very least, we should make it to the cave to scout it out, find exactly what we're up against, because, you know, the Kelpies may not have the Aetherstone in their caves. It may still be out on the ship.
Can Tangent start, adventuring a hex ahead of the party?
Nope, because that's a whole half day's travel.
Oh.
Yeah, we could check the caves. We'll check the caves, and if it looks like it's too much for us, we can go get the goblins.
Dude's gonna do it one more time, and this time she's gonna pull out the fidget spin, and it starts spinning.
It's not existing here, but it is very accurate that you would have a fidget spinner, I agree. Yeah.
Alright, one other suggestion before we leave. We could travel back to the fireworks and carry as many explosives as we can with us to try to explode the cave.
Also maybe be a good idea.
How many fireworks
if the Aetherstone is in the cave, that would not be the best idea.
Also, the fireworks stash that you guys had found is about 2 days behind you guys.
Let's just go to the cave and check it out. Okay. Maybe we can kill enough Kelpies one by one to where we don't have to face them all.
Or we could, challenge their leader if that's actually an option.
Well, let's get going. We'll figure it out on the way there.
Alright, so where are you guys going?
Proceed.
Are you searching for the shipwreck of the Kelpies?
Yep. Yes.
All right.
We should search the wreck before we go straight into them.
Alright, and I take it you guys are going to be not directly on. It sounded like you guys were kind of staying up in the away from the shore. Exactly, kind of staying a little bit hidden.
Yes.
Yeah.
Alright, you guys start traveling, and along the coast as you guys start your traveling, I need perception checks.
Gione.
No, perception.
Wait, do we all roll perception?
Unless you don't want to.
Okay, let me hear.
Well, I don't see shit, Captain, holy shit.
Blind if you can.
Wait.
Blind perception rolls for?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
What are you rolling perception rolls for?
You guys
we'll find out.
We don't know yet.
Oh.
You know, Grodd, I've seen you roll several skill checks up to this point, and I'm wondering what is good. What is Grodd good at?
What?
I've looked at you roll multiple skill checks, and they all seem to have a +0 modifier. I'm wondering, what is Grodd actually good at?
Being sneaky.
Stealing chicken.
You guys start your traveling, and it's, let's see, Moon Planter, Dayspring, Poutine, and Tangent, who pick up on things long before you guys get to them. And as you guys find a nice little cozy spot of trees to hide behind, I'll definitely move you guys to a different map here so you can see what you spy.
Yeah, I've got low light vision and scent, so that kind of makes sense.
All right, let me refresh here. Is it loading for everybody else?
Black screen for me.
Yeah, black screen.
Click on it twice.
Yep. Yeah.
Or F5, either one.
Dude!
Here, let me refresh.
Also, the game is still paused.
Yes.
That is true.
Black screen, should I refresh?
I'm refreshing. Still black screen.
Yeah, it's still black for me.
Let me double check.
Yes, still black.
It's still feisty.
Black.
It's still black, but does it matter?
Not he yet. Describes things accurately enough.
Always roleplay that it's, but it's not black.
Down here?
That's kind of racist. Why do you have to roleplay that it's not black?
Is it still black for you guys?
Yep. Still black.
Yeah, still blacked.
It's handing me its fucking mixtape right now. Oh, I saw a flicker. Oh, okay, so it's only half black now.
Oh god, that's a lot of Kelpie.
Yeah, push F5. You guys are pretty much hiding up in the little shrubberies and bushes above here, as you guys do come across finally the shipwreck that has been long since touted by both your good friend Grot and Grop, and they kind of see at least Grop kind of hidden in the bushes.
No, I see things.
Working for me. I hit refresh.
I saw half the screen, but when I refreshed, now I see nothing.
We're at the very top end of the screen, so just scroll down whenever you get it back. Down. That's a lot of Kelpies.
Mm-hmm. Many boys were bust.
I can't scroll. Well, I'm just gonna take your word for it.
Realistically, okay. I'm assuming you guys are kind of off map, about like somewhat in the range of like. Fairly far.
Oh, okay, so it wasn't half, it's just we were at the world's end. Okay.
Yeah, okay, that's what happened.
Okay.
Now you guys are a fair bit off, but a good vantage point to get a scope of what seems to be a lot of green.
Oh my god.
That's a lot of Kelpies.
And they seem to be milling about this shipwreck that, as you guys kind of look about it, seems to have some fairly nice little crates about, and they seem to be kind of pushing and fashioning things from the wood and wreckage, and generally being Kelpies.
And what is it to identify these? Knowledge nature?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Does anyone in our party have knowledge nature?
We can't possibly handle all these Kelpies.
Well, not with that attitude.
Heck? But I don't think I do. Wouldn't you have more knowledge nature than us, since you're a hunter-gatherer, it seems? Wouldn't you have the best?
Well, no, I don't. I'm more specialized in trekking through the land, and I just live off of it.
Mm-hmm. Does anyone have knowledge nature? I don't.
Oh, I have, yeah.
Derp? We've been asking for it.
Yeah, let's... Derp.
Listen. Blind? Probably blind.
Wait, what are we rolling for?
To identify the Kelpies and learn more about them.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure we see that they're Kelpies, right?
Right, but monsters and different creatures have special abilities and supernatural abilities we might not be aware of.
Hey, wait, they can wander randomly without someone moving them?
Oh yeah, Mimili should have a fucking path thingy.
Cool.
Based?
It is pretty buggy. I don't actually have that set up for here. I'm just moving him around.
Yeah, I think he's just moving.
Oh, okay.
Mimili's just playing with his toys.
Yeah. Alright, as soon as we get information on this knowledge, I have an idea, but I want to hear what we've got.
It looks like, Dayspring, you can ask me one question about the Kelpies.
Well, we already know they're named Kelpie, huh?
Ask no, their weak to.
Yeah.
I actually ask their weakest save.
Okay, weakest save?
Well, typically, you'd find that a Kelpie's weakest save is likely their fortitude.
I guess that makes sense.
Alright. Okay, everyone be quiet, I have an idea. I have the skin of that Kelpie from before. What we're going to do is we're going to put this skin on Grub. He's going to cause a huge distraction and try to bring them over to us. And we're going to be lying in ambush. And as soon as they get here, we're going to jank them all.
You want to bring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of them all? To us, more actually.
I have some sapper training. I'll lay out my traps. I can ensnare some of them. I can do damage to others where they can't move. The rest of them, while they're being held in place, if they're not dead already, we should be able to take care of.
This feels like a real Leroy Jenkins moment. I don't know, fam.
Except we're not running in. They're coming to us.
Okay. I guess if everyone else is in agreement.
Can I set up like one of those classic noose traps with the rope from a tree going down with like a noose?
Unless you have training in doing that, that would be very noisy.
Likely do you have training?
Yes.
Okay, I give you my rope.
Do you always have rope?
I don't know, because I read it was one of those things adventurers always should have but never buy.
She's right, yeah. Always have rope.
Incredibly right. That always happens. Yeah. Like...
Okay. So, Mamely, would you permit me to plot out where I'm going to be putting traps?
You can probably draw it, I think.
Right, I just want to make sure
I can. Yeah, you could use these to indicate where...
Okay, actually I'm going to draw, so that way everyone can see. Where's the drawing thing?
That's roll 20.
There's a pencil tool.
Right, but I don't see it.
On the left?
I'm clicking on the left, it's not coming up.
I don't see it either. It's like I only have three tabs enabled. The notes.
Yeah, I suppose. Is that a...
Okay.
Is that a setting? Let's see. Draw. That I have to enable.
Delete the shape that I drew.
You drew that. Okay.
That was me. Sorry. I was trying to figure out which one was pencil.
Yeah, I need something to mark with an X or a circle. That's all I need.
Yeah, I'm looking.
Circle is right here.
Well, that's for like an area. I need something small just to fit in a square.
Yeah, yeah. I'm looking for the option that lets you guys draw things on the map. That's something I actually never really looked into.
Do we have to have permission to do that? Is it locked?
I would guess so. This has permissions for everything. Let's see.
Okay. While you look that up, I'll go ahead and start planning. So essentially what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up various snares along this tree line. I have six potentially lethal traps. That can be staked into the ground, so if something snaps it off and it gets caught, then it'll get stuck there. So that will take care of up to six of them. Snare traps can entangle. I can build some nooses. I can also just build like a line trap to try to trip them up as I run. But we should be able to potentially, if not remove, just disrupt about half of them. And then we can fight the other half, weaken them, and then finish off the rest.
Fixed, potentially with just one trap, then that already puts it at like, or multiple traps, puts it at pretty easy odds for us.
They likely won't be killed, but they will be stuck in place because the trap is staked into the ground.
Alright, so you're making it along the tree line, yeah?
Right.
Where at?
Let's see. So the plan is we're going to have Grot wear the skin. He's going to make a... Or not Grot, but Grub. He's going to wear the Kelpie skin, make a bunch of noise, and get them to chase after him. And we're going to lead them up into this portion of the tree line. And I'm going to be setting up bear traps. I have three bear traps and three offset bear traps. The only difference is... The bear trap does 2d6 damage, and the offset does 1d6, but is more difficult to escape from. So we're going to set up the bear traps through here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in this open space here, I'm going to set up a trip line. And then in this tree, I'm going to set up two snare traps with rope. So that way, if they go through it and get stuck, then you know they'll be hung up there until they can pull out of it.
All right, you're pretty close to the shoreline with those, so I will need a stealth check if that's what you're doing.
I suck at stealth, but I could take my time and just take a 20 on that.
And that is not a take a 20 thing. Take a 20 implies that you are constantly failing, which I don't think you want to do.
No.
I think Mimley has said this a lot of times.
He really has.
You can hear the irritation in his voice. Like, he's like...
All right, well, here's the problem. Stealth is not a class skill for me, or excuse me, it's not a trained skill, and I'm wearing medium armor, so I take heavy negatives.
You take your armor off.
Can you just do that?
That's still going to leave me on heavy negatives.
It takes like 5 minutes to put your armor back on if it's heavy, though.
It's medium armor, so I think it's like 2 minutes for me to... Or it's like 30 seconds for me to take it off, 2 minutes for me to put it on.
Alright, so that's like 12 rounds of combat that it takes to put it on if we get caught.
True. When it comes to setting up traps, is there any skill-related check that needs to be made for that, or can they just do it?
Do you have craft traps?
I do, yes. But that's for, like, building and, you know, actually making them. These are already made. They just need to be set. Like, can I set the trap and then have somebody else carry it off to where I show them?
I think that that's fine.
See what my stealth.
Let me just double check really quick.
Like carrying an armed bear trap.
Oh, my stealth is -6. I'm useless.
Why are your stats so bad? Are cats supposed to be good at climbing and sneaking around and stuff?
I took one hat and I'll tell you why. It's armor check penalty.
I figured. All right. Grot, you're good at sneaking, aren't you?
A little.
Okay. If you hold, and while he's explaining, he sets the bear trap, and y'all hear this very faint as everything sets into place. If you hold the trap by this extended portion here, it will not go off so long as you do not touch this plate in the middle. Make sure that the plate is buried underneath the dirt. And I want you to put it along the tree line over there. I have 6 of them, so come back for each one.
I like how you guys haven't described to Grop what he's doing yet. He's just kind of been sitting there like a good boy, just listening.
There.
And Grop points.
Oh, yeah.
No, the bear traps are going to go over there.
Are you pointing something like... oh, there it is. I wasn't zoomed out enough.
Yeah, if you see where the first 6 white X's are, that's going to be the bear traps. And then the 2 X's next to us are going to be snare traps. So the traps are going to be set by me. I'm going to hand them off to Grot, and then Grot, you sneak and carry them over and set them in place.
Watch me fail the first roll.
I've been rolling
too good so far. Okay. All right, so Grot is going to take it and slowly sneak over.
All right, give me that stealth check.
Let's see. I should put this on my macro bar. Oh, can't put it on my macro bar. Okay. Oh, yeah, there it is.
You are no good at stealth. You said you were good at stealth.
She's a little bit good. Oh, whoops.
A plus
you're one.
I thought you were a dex build.
She is.
How do you have a plus
really
one
bad
if you're
at
a dex build? I'm thoroughly confused here. I have no idea what your class is or what your skills are. I thought you were going to be all sneaky and stuff.
We have a bunch of people with, like, the opposite of what their classes should be. A cat that can't climb or sneak. A goblin who can't sneak. Like,
okay, well, I'd probably stop the obviously not stealthy goblin.
There's a little bit of a clink, clink, clink as they start walking. And you see this Kelpie's ears way over here just kind of flicker just a little bit.
Okay, we're gonna hunker down for the time being.
Hey, Hulk.
Don't.
I put it down.
I mean, Dayspring has a +2. Does anyone have better?
I have a +0.
Do we seriously not have a rogue in the party? What about stealth?
Brad is a rogue.
Okay, for real, just to spare my sanity, Grot, will you please explain what your class is and what you're good at?
Shit, what was my, hold on.
Do I have a spell?
Why are you hating Pathfinder?
Grot is good at stealing.
Oh,
apparently
my,
not sneakily.
What was my subclass again? I actually don't remember the name of it.
Are you multi-class?
Hang on, let me send you something here, Grot, in DMs, just so you can do something. I think you got your stats wrong here. Let's see.
I mean, that doesn't seem really low for a rogue.
Yeah, that doesn't those. Even... If you're a dex build, which if you're a rogue, you probably should be, that doesn't even account for your dex modifier.
Yeah.
Yeah, I DM'd
Something
you.
Might be wrong with my sheet, actually.
I DM'd you your skills.
My skills kind of imported wrong a little bit, so it's possible.
Oh, my stealth should be plus 7. What the fuck?
Oh, okay.
That makes more sense.
Why is my sheet off? Hold on, I'm going to fix my...
It's because the ranks never came over. I just put in your ranks in there and it brought it up to the proper.
Okay. I will fix things in my skills.
So that's a 13. I just typed that in Celestial.
Well, let's just have her re-roll it.
Okay, yeah, we can have her re-roll it for fun.
So that we can get a better one.
Better be blind.
Yeah, that one.
Oh, we all there now.
I hope not.
What the fuck?
Language.
Watch your one? Profanity.
Okay. There it is.
That was supposed to be blind.
Oh, blind shit.
Well, no, it's okay. It works. It's perfectly fine. 17, you know. Right, mainly is good.
Blind.
Oh. Here we go. Let's do it.
Nice. Hey. A slightly more stealthy Grot starts, pattering over, and you guys do hear still the light clink, 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 clink. Still not.
Oh no.
Oh gosh.
Hey, I tried sending it in a different language and it didn't work.
Mind me.
And Grout is gonna place it.
Mm-hmm.
Does she bury it like I told her to?
Yeah, she throws a bit of sand over it.
Okay, that's good.
And she, do I have to roll another stealth coming back, or?
Yep.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh no.
Doing this like 12 times back and forth.
It'll
she's
be okay.
She's gonna get a really low
Trust
roll
me.
One time.
One of them kind of perks up and starts kind of rolling onto the sand, looking in that direction. He looks back. You hear them say something. And a couple of them stop, look up, start kind of right over here.
We're gonna just hunker down and be still.
Can I cast?
They don't seem to go much further than here, though. They seem to be kind of half dragging themselves onto the land.
Do they move slower on the land?
They don't seem to move very fast at all on the land.
Okay.
Nor do they seem to be going much past here. These ones seem to be staying kind of in that, like, splashy zone of the water as Grot is placing the traps, and they seem to be squinting.
So they're all... Are they looking in this direction or across the entire beach?
They seem to have been roughly following Grot's process all the way back. So at this current point, they're kind of looking in this direction.
This isn't going nearly as well as I hoped.
What run?
Okay, what's... Okay, I know it would be off map, but I imagine, like, past here, the forest is much denser, which you have an easier time of sneaking through this area and then coming, like, up in a horseshoe pattern.
I mean, what's been done has been done. Like, the rolls have been made.
Right, we can't take that first one back, but we have more traps to set. So what if she were to go into the deeper portion? Would she have better cover?
If you'd like, yeah.
All right, I think we should do that. All right, Grot, this time I want you to go deep, farther back into the woods, and then come back over to the same spot and set another trap.
More green, okay.
And Grot grabs another one of those traps and make the roll.
Grop is also going to take one to help.
Okay. Yeah, if Grop can show him what's going on, this will go faster.
And Grop. And this is a much more stealthy attempt, as now there is little clinking. It's a little bit more sneaky. Doot, 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 doot.
Okay, that's three traps.
Are still looking in this direction.
And there's kind of like a rock or something right here, so do we have cover?
Yeah.
Okay. And while they're gone, Moon Planter will set up two more traps. These will be the offset bear traps.
Oh yeah, yeah, he has to also roll this.
Oh boy.
What is that noise?
Someone's phone.
Oh. Yeah.
Don't bully my android.
Thankfully, this isn't breaking my immersion.
Let's hear this.
That's actually the sound of the Kelpies investigating us.
They're using echolocation.
Yeah.
Do not disturb for some reason doesn't meet my notifications. I don't know why.
And you give them new traps, I take it, yeah?
Yes, two new traps.
And you start taking them over. To set them up. And their ears flicker. And they start kind of that way. They're just scanning this whole forest now. They're looking this way. They're very suspicious.
Yeah. It's okay. So far, so good. All right. Three more traps to set. Everybody keep a cool...
Is it possible to prepare a spell to cast without casting it and hold it at the ready?
That preparing a spell also implies that you are partially casting the spell. They might have verbal components, and unless you have silent spell, there's probably not a way you're casting it quietly. That's if it has verbal components. Spell casting in Pathfinder specifically says that you are pretty much shouting loudly to the world to cast your spell, which is why the metamagics are important.
Most of these have component B, so not many of them are silent. Just wondering.
Alright, so Moon Planter hands off the final bear trap to Grub, and then to Grot, he gives a snare trap to put into the tree right here. And I really wish I could have brought my crossbow trap with me, but that would have weighed me down too much.
And the final roll seems to go off flawlessly. They don't even seem to notice Grot in any sense. Their eyes don't travel along where she's going.
Yep, Grot. A crossbow trap is a crossbow set up on a tripod with a trip wire, and if you trip the wire, then it shoots at you. And you can poison the bolts to make it, extra damaging. It's nasty stuff.
It's like a shotgun trap.
And I guess I'll take the last one?
Yes, snare trap.
Okay.
Oh, and then the 50-foot of rope that was given to me by Tangent, you're going to carry that with you along with the snare trap, and we're going to kind of put it into the tree line back here. And Moon Planter is going to hold on to the other end of it. Pretty sure that's enough length.
I think that rope is sold in 50-foot increments. I thought about buying more.
50 foot's good.
Don't you still have that, 10-foot pole?
That was the other character?
Did Kelpie actually, walk, or are they just floating?
I don't think a 10-foot pole would be useful here, would it? I've got a short spear.
I don't know.
So what I have is a collection of short spears, and I set them on fire and throw them.
Alright, that sounds good. Get ready to do that. Everyone step over the rope, because when they start coming this way, I'm going to charge out with the other end of the rope that's tied around this tree, and I'm going to see if I can either wrap them up or trip them. And then everybody follow behind me.
So you want us to be here?
No, just like make sure the rope is in front of your hooves and paws, so that way I don't pull out from underneath you.
All right.
So.
All right, Grot, did you tie the end of the rope to that tree?
So like this, right?
Yeah. Oh wait, do I have to make a roll to tie it, or?
No, just like double knot it.
Definitely. Oh, okay.
I mean, hopefully you know how to
double knot things. Yeah. I guess she would. She did her own robes up. So
yeah, you don't have to have a merit badge to know how to tie a rope, but it helps. Okay.
Well, then she did.
All right.
What kind of skill is it to throw things? I just need to know.
The range attack.
Range attack?
Yeah, it's a BAB plus dex modifier.
Thanks.
All right. Grot, I need you to translate this to Grep, because this is the important part of the plan. If this botches, we're probably going to die. All right,
no.
Grot. All right. Everyone in Ushanka is going to die. All right, Grep, take this Kelpie skin. I want you to put it on. And I want you to run through these trees and make a bunch of noise over here. Like, scream at them. But just be careful of the traps. Don't trip them. And I want you to get as many Kelpies as you can to chase you into those woods, and then scream at the top of your lungs coming back this way. And then as soon as the Kelpies make it to this tree line right here, I'm going to run out with the rope to try to ensnare them, and then everybody else attack at the same time. This will be a massive coordinated attack, so make sure your attacks are ready, your spells, your spears, your music, whatever you're going to have. But we don't need to draw any attention to us until the Kelpies reach this point. Is everyone ready?
Oh, I see it. It's so thin. Okay.
Yes. Grot is going to fish out that old tankard that she had back at the bar. and she gives it to him. Go around, avoid trap, make noise, lots of noise. Hit this.
And
she's gonna give it to him.
And he looks at it, mightily proud, and then goes over very quietly to Warboss. Grot, you hear him say, please bless this war drum.
Oh. Alright,
This is not the intended purpose of the war drum, but now I'm kinda glad we made it.
Bless raid.
All right. If Grot translated, so she'll just like put a hoof on it and be like, "May this drum protect you."
And he looks mightily proud, taking a deep breath, starting to run. He kind of runs back here just a little bit far away. He looks to you guys and then just starts beating the hell out of this this mug here. And just starts like screaming, running around the traps right over here, generally making a big ruckus, which naturally exclamation mark points over everybody's head now is turning this way.
Run.
Sound.
He kind of runs out right over here, goes and he's doing his darndest, which I will give him proper rules for. Don't you worry. Let's see. Aha, there it is. And he seems to be doing a good job of it, as a couple of them snarl his way. Though as a couple over here start to kind of go up. The one that had come forward over here kind of puts up a hoof. They look to him and they stop. And he kind of shambles partially up onto the land over here to the very distracting Agabo that is clanging around the traps over here frantically, doing his things. And then
it's not working.
And that's when you see the Kelpies start to open up their mouths and let loose a very, very alluring sort of song, almost. Singing out toward Mr. Gabo. Let's see.
It's okay. Grub has like a plus 27 to his will save. He'll be fine.
Yeah.
Does he?
Yeah, we'll be okay.
And as this one starts singing, he slows down just for a minute. He slows down, slow, and he looks over. And then he kind of shakes it away. He starts acting like all girly. He squints very somewhat angrily, looking toward one of his compatriots, who also starts singing. Toward your friend here. And as the second one kind of joins in chorus to sing, your friend, your dear Grop, kind of stops and blinks. And he just kind of like, he stops banging the mug and he just continues looking at this one all curiously.
Guys, I think we might need the help.
Plan B, go.
Go.
No, Goblet's on its own.
All right, are you guys rolling initiative?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Are you abandoning the plan already?
This wasn't part of the plan.
What's initiative again?
If you go to the fist tab, and you can mm-hmm.
Holy shit, that's
okay,
a big
Grok roll. Okay, can save him.
Okay, wait. I guess I'll roll initiative.
The easiest way to do it is with the fist, because they have a little dice next to your roll.
He wasn't supposed to be dancing in front of them. He was supposed to make noise and go back into the tree line.
He stayed in the tree line.
But
yeah, he did.
He did. They just don't follow him.
They don't seem to be straying too far from the water, is what I'm saying.
I guess a seafaring group isn't gonna come deep into the forest for one goblin,
Deep into the forest? It's like 70 feet away.
That's like deep into the forest for a creature that loves water.
All
those
right.
Sea lovers.
It's okay, you can collect your traps when we're done.
It is this one's turn in the water here. Let's see. Yep, I gotta push the space bar. And he is, for his turn, moving this way. Swishing through the water very fast. A lot faster than he seems to be on land. Oh, no, that was his double move here. Grot, it is your turn.
Okay. Hold on. I'm gonna see what, with charge, it's just double your movement speed, right?
Mm-hmm. If it's a charge, it's double your movement speed, but you have to be in a line, but you could end your charge in an attack on something if it's in a straight line.
Yeah, okay, I don't have enough movement speed.
Actually, I thought it was four times or something.
That's right.
You know who does have enough movement speed? Me.
Let's see.
Fuck. Roll your initiative, by the way.
I guess I'll sneak around this time.
I think it's this.
There you go.
Let's see. Yeah, I can make it. I can do a charge attack and make it there.
You're going to be surrounded if you do.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll go ahead and roll my stealth.
Well, not if you all come with me.
We don't have the same charge.
So you think I should charge for the nearest?
If you are rolling stealth, keep in mind you're moving at half speed in Pathfinder rules.
Yeah, okay. That's my full movement then.
Okay, yeah.
Kind of stay low on the ground and try to get closer.
Mm-hmm. They still all seem, as you sneak out here, to be looking toward this one. I don't seem to have noticed yet.
I'm trying to.
Behind this rock, Grot, I want to point out in this direction was one of those boxes that they might have been looking at between these rocks. I'll put a little square on it. Close enough to have seen that. Little box.
Grot just kind of investigate that. Maybe it's in there. Maybe we can just, like, leave and abandon the other goblino.
No, we don't want to abandon Grot.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on. I gotta wait for the Steam message to go on so I can click the next person.
That would be Mike.
There we go.
Rioli. I'll be right back.
All right. It is this one's turn here.
give me the Kelpioli.
Who is this one? I'm just putting him on the map here. Lumbers a little bit on land right over here. To our very, very nicely distracted little Kelpie. Or sorry, Gabo. And with a slams in a very slammy way. However, even in such a state, did not seem he had made an attack. Perhaps he is not too good on land. This one is the next one in turn. Uses this moment to get back into the water. And the rest of his movement to move this way. Cher, it is your turn.
Cher is getting ravioli.
Oh, yes.
Terrifying.
Damn it, Cher. All right, I'm gonna give Cher a 15
a
seconds.
Fair minutes.
I'm actually at a disadvantage here as a fire cleric.
Actually, let me just let's update Cher to be 20. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. All right, I'll just move her down on the initiative a little bit.
Yeah, we'll just bump her turn a couple.
It is this one's over here then. He swishes, swish, through the water, swish, swish, swish. And this one's turn, swish, through the water. And this one's, who is...
What's the challenge rating on these guys?
That is for me to know and you to find out. And that was their turn. We're back to Cher. I'm just gonna keep moving Cher down. Which means that...
Cher's just thinking really hard.
Yeah.
Damn, how low am I on the initiative list?
Look in the fight tab, there's a fist icon, and you could see the initiative here. You're pretty cool. You're pretty low on the totem.
It
on this
just
one.
So happened that all the Kelpies rolled fairly high.
Wow, I am low.
And is this one's turn? Just swishing upwards this way, whoosh, but otherwise looks like he's holding his turn. This one goes this way. Whoosh, whoosh. This one stays put where they are. It is this one's turn up here. It lumbers back to the water a little bit, whoosh, whoosh, which is their turn. And this one, who is pretty much the one that was commanding, lumbers back just a little bit. Do-do-do-do-do-do. That's about as far as they get. Moonplanter, it is your turn.
Moonplanter is freaking lost. Alright, Moonplanter is going to hold on to the rope, and he's going to move in the direction of these traps. Question, does medium armor reduce your land speed?
I don't think so.
Okay.
You're asking somebody who namely plays characters that never have armor. Like,
right.
Heavy armor reduce your land speed?
Heavy armor does for sure, but I didn't know about medium armor. Mm-hmm. Alright. And I'm a leather wing, so I think I've only got 30 feet of movement. Yeah, okay, so I can only move 60 feet. I'm going to hold on to the rope and double move to here. To right there, deep in the forest.
Move yourself.
I'm still trying to lure them into the trap, or...
No.
I'm gonna stay out of sight, out of mind for the moment.
Hey, Cher's back. Cher's turn is next.
Yay.
Alright, and that will be my turn.
Alright, let me move Cher after Moonplanter. You left at a very unfortunate time. You're at the top of the initiative, my guy.
Now all these Kelpies go before us.
Alright. I put Cher after Moonplanter. What are you doing, Cher?
How loud would my summon be?
We're not stealthing anymore.
Okay.
Well, you haven't acted yet, so you might be able to stay stealth if you want to.
There's no point in me living if all of you die anyway.
Hey, that's the spirit.
Let me just make sure. Because I know I can summon a creature and stuff, but I just want to make sure, like, a bird is on the list.
I have a safe.
But can I use the summon creature and summon creature bird?
Summon creature bird.
Shine eagles, yeah.
Alright, so summoning spells, keep in mind, are usually full round actions. Is that correct for you?
Yep.
Yep. So that means that you start casting it now, and on your next turn, that's when all the eagles come in.
Yep. Well, single eagle. Did I get more than one?
Or, which summon are you using?
Just summon. Yeah.
Summon. If you're casting the spell, you can click on it, and it'll post, and then we can read the description.
Okay.
There are many spells in Pathfinder. Those do help.
Oh.
So, to the left of
me. Why are all the cleric spells touch attacks?
They're not, just a lot of the good ones are. So next to the name of the spell, there's a hooded figure, and if you hover over it, it turns into a d20. Just click on that, and it'll post the spell description in the chat.
Oh, is it my turn? Oh, no, it's
your turn. Wait, where's the... I can see the d20, but it's not hooded.
There it is. I got it.
There it is.
Alright, so yeah. One round, so it'll... You spell, you summon an extra planar creature. All right, yeah, cool. Just one. And you said you're doing an eagle?
Yep.
Fantastic. All right. Be sure in the off to pull up the stats for your eagle when it comes your next turn. Poutine.
I see my friends are being stupid. I'll join.
You join?
I joined. It's not touch, but it's like close.
I need to remember how to move.
You select yourself with the people's icon on the upper left. There's like a little square selector icon. And I'll push spacebar. Yep.
I'm gonna sing a song of my people.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. It's called Stop Being an Idiot.
Are you singing
That's
or honking?
That's not be the song of your people.
I am using... Counter Song.
Oh, nice.
And that will be my turn for now.
Alright,
I should roll performance.
Well, any creature within 30 feet of you that is affected by these things can use... Yes, use that. Now, I'm not sure if he is within... He's a little out of your range for that.
I know. I'm getting there.
Oh, okay. Fair.
Are you playing as you're walking, or...?
I walk, then I start playing.
And then you walk a little bit more, and you start playing? And...
I shall continue doing. That's my turn.
Alright, it is the Kelpie's turn right after you, which is this one right here. I'm just double checking. Yep. Who looks over at you, Mr. Duding Bard. Squints. You see them open up their hoofy jowls and sing in your direction. Sing. Let me just make sure. Yep. Give me a will save. And if you're, your will save is fine, so you don't need to roll your performance. You had no problem resisting the urges of this definitely not sexy Kelpie. And he started singing seductively towards you. Look at that. Sea creatures, man. And that's what he was doing for his turn. It is this one's turn who backs up into the sea. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. It is now the one that is singing toward your gobbo friend over here, this one down here, who, as they continue singing, slowly start to back up into the water. Get to about there. Tangent, it is your turn.
I am going to use my unnaturally high move speed to move out. I'm actually not going to use the full amount that I can move. I'm going to move here to behind this rock.
Oh.
So, hold on. Oh, it's... sorry, I had to move the movement thing. Okay, I don't know how to move the thing, but I moved to here.
Womp.
Thank you.
There you are. And you just kind of run there?
Yeah, I think that it's a full round action to cast a spell, isn't it?
It's usually a normal action. Depends on the spell. It usually tells you what kind of action it is.
Yeah, it says one standard action, so...
Yep, then you're good. You're good to cast it.
Yep. Oh, wait, I can still take an action?
Mm-hmm. Then you just used your movement. You have an action still.
Oh, well, there's nobody in range. I think. Hold on, let me measure it real quick. How far are you from me? What do you know? It's 25 feet, but it's, like, just out of range.
35.
It's 25 plus 5 feet every 2 levels, so I guess I can cast up to 30 feet. So I can just barely reach this guy with my spell, which I will do. I'm going to cast Sound Burst.
Well, no, it's if it's for every 2 levels, then you have a 30 foot range. He is 35 feet away from you.
Oh, okay. Well, alright.
Yeah, you got to count your square too.
Yep. Ruler tool is best for that, not the area of effect tool.
Oh, where's the ruler tool? Is this it?
The ruler tool's up in the top, like, basic controls person icon, yeah.
I'll just wait until the next round comes around.
Alrighty. It is your good dear friend Gobbo's turn up here, who is still looking toward this one that is singing with an adoration as he just starts walking into the water after her.
That shit.
Splish, splish, splish. And he kind of gets up to his like underbelly in the water, just following them. And this one just lets it happen. No attack of opportunity. Dayspring, it is your turn.
There we go. I'm gonna punch this one.
Charge, my ticket?
Yes.
Alright, you get a +2.
I'm gonna use that, because it works for the same thing.
Well, I'm glad I prepared silence today. Nobody in range.
Alright, let's see this. Let me, sure that's not gonna repeat. There we go. Alright, you slash out to go attack this here Kelpie. And do make a mark as you hit them with impunity for 9 damage. Yes.
Yep.
And they take that 9 damage, making a very weird, horsey, gurgling noise at you. It's not too pleasant. Not too pleasant. Not too pleasant. But you did make a mark. Now a couple of them are looking at you, oh war boss.
And that is the charge.
All right. And it is this one's turn out in the water already. Hey, Warboss. You got a secret admirer. Somebody's singing towards you. Give me a will save.
All right. Watch me, like, immediately fail. Will. I need to check one of my features, actually. Hang on. Is this mind affecting?
It is.
Nice. I need to... -1, -3... And... God, I wasn't... This is actually hard to calculate. So I use my charisma bonus on the... I guess I could just roll and say add 3. Yeah, alright. Will. Okay. Why? What if we add three? Yeah. Plus three.
And you do make your save, as the wiles of this here Kelpie do not affect you. Grot.
Yes.
The things don't seem to have noticed you, but have certainly noticed your friend up here. What are you doing?
All right. Shit, I wasn't done editing my attack, but... let's see. See if I'm in range now. I am not in range of anybody. I'm gonna keep sneaking.
Where are you sneaking to?
See.
You should go to the square to investigate what they were originally going to.
Normally you can't hide in plain sight, but there is a lot of things that are taking their attention away, so I'll
allow
it here.
1, 2, 3.
Alright, yeah.
And I'll duck behind the box for now, and I'll take a little peek.
Take a little peek?
If I can.
Yeah, yeah. I'll say
just that's into the box if it's open.
That'll be your action, alright.
Yeah.
You take a peek, and Let me open up this note here really quick, which is on this map actually. Give me 1 second, and I'll screenshot this for you. Zoom. All right. Grot. A bunch of fancy things greet you.
Neat.
Yes, yes. Seems like they've been just using this box as a stockpile as they sifted through this wreckage. Let's see. And that being your turn, it's now the various Kelpies. This one, who initially smacked the Gabo, is now retreating back into the water. Gets to about here on land. This one...
I believe Grop is gonna die.
Can't believe Grop's gonna die.
This one
not even here. My fault.
This one over here is swishing this way. Swish, swish, swish.
You guys get to him and, like, can pull him out of the grapple before they get him any further. We could save him.
This one actually comes forward a little bit. Whoosh. And Dayspring, he starts singing. Give me another will save.
The battle of multiple sings. Okay. Again. I don't know if plus three helps that.
Alright, plus three unfortunately does not help that. And as it starts to sing, this orc helpy over here starts to seem to be the most beautiful, amazing thing you have ever seen in your entire life. It makes you want to walk in a straight line toward it on your next turn.
So unfair.
I know. It's almost as if we picked the wrong fight.
It is this Kelpie's right here's turn, who also retreats back into the water a little bit. Not too much entirely. That one stays where it's at. Most of these are staying where it's at. Bonk, bonk. Except for this one over here. Moves a little bit away from his friend to let him do his thing. Look at that. This one, who looked like he was about to start singing, moves back a little bit. And the others do not do much. Moon Planter, it is your turn.
You ain't off to cry.
You're muted.
Of course I am. Thank you. Moonplanter is going to abandon his rope, so he's going to drop it right here in the square. And he's going to move up. That's 30 feet. Let's see. He's going to move up to right here. And he's going to grab a hold of the Ringed One to make sure that she doesn't walk into the ocean. Actually, no, I can charge. Can I charge and perform a dirty trick?
Your adventure, not mine.
Would that
Okay.
Wait. Charge and do a dirty trick. Technically, no. That is a combat maneuver, not a direct like swingy attack. That wouldn't give you a plus two, unless what is your dirty trick? I guess.
I was gonna pick a hoof full of sand and throw it in this thing's eyes so it's blinded.
I don't think that's something you could do while charging.
Yeah.
You can't do CMBs while charging, I don't believe.
I know you can grapple on a charge, but if you say no, then that's fine. Moonplanter will run up right here and grab the ringed one to make sure she doesn't go into the water. So.
Yeah, you can only do certain CMB rules while charging, namely like things like bull rushing.
I don't know what to do then.
Are you trying
like this? This was my entire combat strategy over here, so I'm kind of out of luck unless I just get in something's face.
So you moved up. Are you doing anything? Sorry, to Dayspring. Or are you able to?
No, can't grappler. Can't do a dirty trick. So that's where I move to.
Alrighty.
Could try to attack. Maybe I don't know if that helped.
Not sure.
Hang on, I'm falling.
I feel like
you gotta swallow that load.
I feel like that's something Cher would just say in this situation at the moment. Just eating some berries in the background.
Hold on, boy. Alright, how do I do the ruler? Okay, here we go. Oh man, I gotta zoom in. I can't read that.
Yes, your ethereal eagle whoosh into existence.
That's 75 feet, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
It says my eagle. Here, I'll send you the thing so you can fact check me in case I'm wrong. Message. There you go. It says my eagle can move 80 feet. Fly 80 feet, rather. And then can it perform a normal action or a normal attack too? It says two talons
if
plus
could,
three.
Yeah, if it could fly 80 feet, you can make that. That is its movement, so you can move and then it could attack. It can't do a full attack, but it could definitely attack once with one of its natural attacks.
Yeah. So natural attack would be just the melee, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. It says two talons plus three. Plus 3, 1d4. I'm not actually sure what is this math. It says plus 3 brackets plus 3.
If it says plus 3 plus 3, that means it normally has two attacks on a full round. You just do one of those at plus 3.
Okay. And there are 1d4 plus 2?
Yep, per attack, yeah.
Okay. So, I'm going to send my birdie. Hang on.
Right there?
No,
trouble there?
Why can't I move?
You gotta click yourself, and then from yourself, draw the measure tool.
No, I'm trying to move the map back up.
Oh,
it's left click, okay.
Yeah, left click.
And we will send it right. Is this one in range? This one is also in range.
I will
send it.
Okay.
BCS, your turn is coming up here soon. Oh, she's already gone.
Okay, how do I move the. Put it right there, Mimli. Yeah.
I got you.
And then I will attack you. And so it's. 1d4 plus...
1d20 plus 3 first.
Okay, so 1d20 plus 3.
Mm-hmm. Slash roll 1d20 plus 3.
Yeah. 20 plus 3. Oh, did that need to be blind?
You don't need to make it blind. Not for combat.
Okay, so it's 17.
They hit.
Yay!
Give me that 1d4 plus 2, I believe you said the damage was.
Yep, 1d4.
I'm just moving this so I can get to their health
bar. 1d4 plus 2. I keep doing it blind, but...
You're good.
So that is 6.
Alright, I took off 6 from them. Is that your your eagle makes a mixed contact. Slash, slash. Don't look too happy about that. Poutine!
Poutine! It's me!
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm back.
Hello, back. I want to save my friends, but I don't... None of these people here are my friends. So I'm just gonna kill Kelpies.
Are you keeping up your counter performance as a free action?
Word.
Yeah.
Okay. Let I wasn't sure.
New performance.
Well,
because you make a new one each round.
Yeah.
Oh well, I guess I'm gonna try to help out my buddy.
Strategically position yourself such that they're both within the thing.
Which means that your goblin friend and Dayspring both get another save. Look at that. And by another save, I mean it's Poutine's roll, yeah.
Yeah.
Here comes the
Nice.
Awesome. And taking that save, both your gobbo friend and Dayspring break out of it.
Yeah.
Wow.
And he shakes his head. And he looks down. He looks terrified. He's in the water.
Oh, shower!
Roth, come back.
All right.
That's my turn.
Why
now
is Cher hiding in the back?
Because they are bitches.
Cher sent her bird to attack.
I sent my bird to attack and help Dayspring.
And she's an arcanist. They're very soft.
Dayspring and the bird get an attack of opportunity as this one starts lumbering back into the water.
I will very much take that.
Go for it. As well as your bird, Malamus.
Wait, am I flanking with the bird? Probably not.
No, you're not flanking, no. So, Malamus, you'd give me another attack roll at the 1d20 plus 3.
Okay.
If you're taking that attack of opportunity. You slash. The 14, however, does not hit it, Dayspring.
Yeah.
And a 15 would not either.
What?
What? I'd be able to land a single hit on these things.
However,
I landed my first attacks.
Your first attack was 17.
Yeah. I was just saying. So she knew.
Alright. These ones stay in the water back here. Take a look at this. This one kind of swishes this way, just watching, waiting. I need to close down Steam because it keeps going over my combat tracker. Can't switch to combat. All right, there we go.
It's the commander. Can we kill him?
The one that was commanding was this one right here. This one over here, however, that had originally been singing at this one, stops, seeing that the duding has broke him out of it. He squints, and just being right next to the Kelpie, or right next to your goblin friend, decides that he's just going to slash him. He's right here.
And
it looks it was a critical hit on your friend, which does confirm, and your gobbo friend takes a whole 9 points of damage from the first critical hit, and the second hits, and he takes another 3.
Specialized goblin, so he's probably okay still, but...
Mm-hmm. Tangent, it is your turn.
I'm going to go... Wait, how do I move? Come on. I think I'm still using the wrong tool. Hold on. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna move here and cast Soundburst.
Alright.
Which I was trying to do last turn. I'm gonna cast it on this guy right here. Okay, so it goes. You blast an area with tremendous cacophony. Oh, wait. Is this gonna affect Rot?
What?
Shit.
What's the radius on it?
Range is close. 25 feet plus 5 feet every 2
That's not the radius. What's the radius?
Oh, 10 foot radius.
You're fine.
No, it should be up.
10 foot radius would get this one. No, that's pretty much the radius it would get.
Alright. Anyway.
Yeah.
Every creature in the area takes 1d8 points of sonic damage and must succeed on a fortitude save to avoid being stunned for one round.
Maybe put it there if you got closer, and then that'd hit all three.
Oh, like here?
Yeah.
I mean, I can move 50 feet in a round, so wherever the optimal placement would be.
If it's here as well, you can get all three of them?
Oh yeah, true, true. Yeah, so you could like back up. Probably don't want to be too close to the water. Since that's where they want us.
They do seem to be trying to get you guys to get in the water.
Why?
It's 25 feet, so let's see.
Never do what your enemy wants.
There, that should be close enough for me to cast.
Alright.
Yep.
And is it just an automatic damage, or do they roll a save against the burst of sound?
It said every creature in the area takes 1d8 points of sonic damage and must succeed on a 4-2 save to avoid being stunned.
Alright.
For one round.
So give me that damage roll then.
Okay, what do I roll?
1d8 points of sonic damage. Right. Must succeed on a successful fortitude. Alright.
Oh, it's blind. Oh, well.
Unblind yourselves, fams. Y'all in combat. 7 points of damage to the surrounding areas. Good damage roll. -7 of that one. -7. -7.
I also have silence prepared, but I haven't had a cost to use it yet.
I do need to roll fortitude, yes? What is your save DC?
Where do I find the fortitude roll?
That should be something that you should be aware of. It is the
It appears on the spells page. Actually, it doesn't anymore.
I have it pulled up on PFSRD. I don't have it.
Yeah, that's just there.
Let's see. Pathfinder. Exact calculation is 10 plus the spell's level plus your ability modifier to cast spells. You're a cleric, which would be wisdom. What is that DC for you?
So 10 plus, so 11
wisdom
plus.
Wisdom
was 11 plus your wisdom modifier.
It's 15 and the modifier is plus 2.
Oh, 13.
Alright. So they need to roll.
They're probably gonna make it.
Well, they said fortitude is their bad save.
Oh, I need to unblind. Take my own advice about that. The first two fail, which the ones I'm taking at are closer to you. They become stunned, yes? Was the effect?
Yeah, for one round.
Alright. They are. Let's see, what would be the best icon for stunned? That's a stunned icon.
You should probably focus their leader, by the way.
Oh, this one's a better one.
Rather than individuals.
Yeah, probably.
Focus their leaders and then cause fear, maybe. To scare off the rest so we don't have to take on their whole group.
I don't have cause fear. I've got silence.
I have cause fear.
Alright.
I'll channel it through the eagle.
Yeah.
My eagle is very scary.
Yeah, I forget who it was, but someone said, hey, you should prepare silence. And another one.
Yeah, wouldn't silence have really helped when we were initially setting up the traps?
It would have, but now that we know that they can sing to us and lure us into the ocean, this would have been a better use of silence.
Yeah.
But yeah, silence definitely works on... being stealthy, because then you are silent so long as you're at radius.
Yeah, so I mean,
I have muffle sound for that, where allies gain a bonus on stealth checks. So if I know we're doing something like that, I can prepare it ahead of time.
But still, you hit three enemies. Good job.
Yeah. And those 21 points of damage.
She hit three, but two of them did not make their fortitude save, so now they're stunned.
Which means they have a -2 penalty to their AC and also lose the dex bonus.
Yay!
So if anyone has ranged attacks, they could use those on them if they want.
Which one uses their dex bonus? Oh, these two.
Both the stunned, yeah.
Yep. The one over here, though, your poor Gabo friend is more not okay with water than fighting this thing. So he is withdrawing. What's wrong? Wabas! Wabas! He's going behind Poutine here. And he takes out his little dagger. Dayspring.
Okay. Wait, was it this one, Commander?
This is the one that was luring your thing. This is the one that was seemed to be kind of leading them a little bit.
Okay.
I'll put a little icon on him.
Your leader boy.
Oh, I thought the one with the special icon was the leader.
Special icon?
Do you mean the one?
Oh wait, is that one of us?
What?
The green pony with the knife?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. He hasn't seen the icon yet.
I just assumed that was a Kelpie.
No, that's been a Kelpie this whole time.
I was about to attack the
All right,
we got that squared away before you did.
Yeah, sure, I'll beat him to death.
Oh my gosh, the Gobble's eyes go so wide, he sees Warboss charging in full.
Alright, and I will take the charge bonus to that, although I'm not going to add it, just because I'm using spell combat this round.
Go for it.
Eyes go wide, rolls nat 1.
Alright. Yeah, that'd be funny.
Oh, such is life.
Here is the first attack.
Ooh, that hits.
And here is the second. Oh, hey, look at that, nat 1. Well, the first one hits.
Yeah. So you make your swing.
I'm channeling the spell through the first attack.
Yeah. All the Gabo sees is you using your amazing ring to swoosh, and suddenly 7 points of damage to this thing swings across its face. Oh, it's wonderful. The ringed one's at it again. Look at that. The second one is more for a flourish, you know. It's fine. All right, what's this spell for?
And that is Touch of Gracelessness, which is being channeled through the first attack.
Hmm. How fancy.
Touch of Gracelessness?
And this one did make the saving throw.
All right, he has the penalty, but he's still taking a penalty.
What is the penalty?
1d6 plus 2, since we're level 3, I think.
Well, I said
and
he makes...
And it's per 2 caster.
He makes the save.
Yeah, that halves it.
Oh, okay, cool.
And he doesn't fall prone to tripping. Falling prone. So he takes minus 2 to his dex.
Alright. See here. Gates the ability. Alright. Minus 2 to his dex. Yeah, just subtract that off here.
Oops. Sorry, absent.
Now 1 point easier to hit.
I know, right? Let me subtract 2 off this. There we go. Bonk. And he is none too happy with this. None too happy with you. That was Dayspring's turn. Means that it is this one's turn. It's already tried to be fancy. Seems like they've gotten their Gabo back. They squint. This one whooshes over here very fast. The water very fast, very fast. Rot.
Yes.
You're next to a box.
I'm having trouble with one of my items on my character sheet, but I am going to take out my light crossbow. And, hold on. Might have to roll the damage manually here, but...
You should just investigate what's in the box first. Maybe there's the Aether Stone and we could just retrieve.
I don't think it is. No, it's something really good, though.
I think Grot already investigated.
Oh.
That was last
time. I guess I could take it.
oh, yeah, retreat there is. Back with the rest of the party.
Yeah, the goblin is gonna take that box and run. She's gonna drag it across this end.
Where are you dragging it?
You're gonna this be way.
Alright, you can drag it at half your speed.
One. And I will use my full round, so... Three. That far.
You start dragging the box. Oops, I'm just gonna do this and cheat drag it.
Oh wow, the box got bigger.
Okay, I'm doing my best. Alright, there we go.
More loot.
The box must be magic. Keeps changing sizes.
Yeah, yeah.
More boss!
Yeah.
More boss, have stone! Let's go!
Oh, and as you shout this, all of them look this way.
Oh no.
Oh no!
Oh no!
In a fit of panic, Grot is going to take one badger from her robe and throw it at this end, but it only goes like here.
Oh.
I'll accept it. Oh no no no.
Oh no no no.
Oh man, you hear War Boss, this leader, shout something very guttural to all of his soldiers in one big and point toward the one gobbo with the box, looking furious as he starts to lash out at you, oh ringed one, ye of many rings. See, did that do the thing? It didn't do the thing. Let me try this again.
I am awaiting the thing.
Douche. Ooh.
Hey, wait.
Oh,
oh wow.
Holy shit.
He's
damn.
He wasn't too happy with his first attack, so his second definitely crit you for 12.
Yeah. two 20s on the second attack.
Oh, Jesus. They are none too happy with you. However, you seem to be giving your other gobbo friend, that is not Grot, quite the show. And you are taking it like a champ, I would think, yes?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, wait.
No, all right. They are crying.
And as the second one hits, you are also grabbed.
Oh, rude?
Yes, by little tenderly vines that grabs you, and you're grappled. Did you apply that to your sheet?
Yes.
Alright.
Oh, I just realized I could have hit apply. Huh.
Lunar hover. HP. There you go. Bonk. There you go. You can see your health. Look at that. He's none too happy. It is this one's turn, who is using their movement. Go this far. That is their turn right there. This one over here is swooshing along the water. Right over here. Oh ho! Grot. I need a will save.
No.
This one pokes out its horsey head and starts singing very violently towards you.
All right.
Danny boy.
Right, it was in combat. Will save, was it?
Yes, will save.
Well, I got a plus one. Let's see how this goes.
Grot, this one sings towards you in the most beautiful voice.
Oh no.
And you hear the box thump to the ground as Grot, you are in its thrall.
Who's singing? Who is it that's singing?
This one is the one that is singing currently.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. Which means
sure,
that...
that's concentration.
So long as it hears the song. This one's got a handle.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see here. He is going to move up here. Although it looks like his friend has it handled, so he's just going to stand on standby. As will this one. Though this one is going to look out toward you, Mrs. Sound Blast. And start singing as well. Sing, 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 sing.
Let's make that save. What am I rolling?
Will.
Will save.
Hold on.
That is,
that's under attributes, right?
It's actually under your summary.
It's It's also in combat.
Oh. Okay.
Hey, there it is.
It took me a moment to find it.
Oh dear.
Wait, is that bad?
Oh gosh.
Yeah. Tangent.
You roll a one, then with a plus five.
The Kelpies are out here with the crits, and we're out here with ones.
This one over here now has you in its thrall. I'll put the little marks on the ones that are thralling you guys. How about that?
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I don't think...
That means I can't break free, right?
Not unless they put you in direct danger. Or your friend Poutine comes to your rescue.
And I was sitting here trying to prepare my thing.
Such is
you've
life.
You still got a while. Poutine can help.
These ones are stunned, yes? For one round?
Yes.
yes. So this one can't do anything. This one over here isn't doing much because it's already in position. This one is also stunned. This one's getting the heck out of dodge because all of his friends are going back to the water. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. Moon Planter, it is your turn. You just saw both two Kelpies pop their heads up, and suddenly your cleric and your ever so gracious little friend Grot look toward the water menacingly.
Yeah, unfortunately, there's not a lot of good options.
Longingly?
Well, if you can help me kick the captain's ass, then Poutine can go help.
Yeah, I'm gonna send the bird after the captain, so if we can have Poutine move over to try to save those two, that would be great.
Well,
maybe
I
should have stayed hidden.
You mean like me?
I can't do sneak attack damage against either of these guys. I could charge that one, or I could combat maneuver that one. If Poutine leaves, we're going to be up a creek, though, because we are right next to the water.
Yeah.
You guys are.
Yeah.
I mean, I think he can move a reasonable amount of distance and still...
Well, would you rather me use the bird than to attack the two that are putting them into a trance?
I just want to point out to you guys, especially some of the folks that are new, one of the combat maneuver things you can do is feint, which is a bluff check against the enemy as a standard action, which makes them lose their dex bonus for you and the other people. It pretty much makes them flinch, and then, you know, your fellow teammates can use sneak attack and things.
Right, but you've got to make a bluff check to do that, and I'm not good at those.
Dayspring is fairly decent at bluff, I think. Yeah.
All right, here's what I'm going to do, and here's what I recommend. We need to get the heck out of dodge while we have an opening. They're obviously going to stay in the water, so we need to get as far away from them as possible. I'm going to move in the direction toward Tangent and Grot, and then we get Poutine to follow up with the aura that she's got, and then we can just grab the chest and get her.
What about Dayspring?
Dayspring needs to move faster than everybody else.
Nice.
So here's what Moon Planter's gonna do. He's gonna go up and let's see. Yeah, I can move to there and I'm gonna grapple Tangent.
Alright. Go for it.
Boom. And then grapple her.
Tangent, you technically do have the ability to still defend yourself. You're not helpless. Are you resisting this grapple? I guess technically you are resisting it because you're trying your best to get to them. So you still have to give me a
CMB, right?
Yep. What is your
go ahead, GM.
Yeah, but you have to give Moon Planter your CMD, which is your combat maneuver defense, and he has to beat that. Which it looks like he rolled a 16.
I see CMD. It's 15.
Okay. Now, so he beat it.
I do provoke because I don't have improved grapple, so you get a free attack against me.
They do not.
Do not? Are you sure?
Yep. I'm. Yeah.
They're pretty much helpless.
Yeah.
Okay then. Yes, we are now both grappled, and Tangent, you are not moving from that spot.
Well, Tangent can still take you with the grapple, I believe, half the movement, but it's restrained movement.
The one who controls the grapple can move half their speed.
Gotcha, okay. Alright.
And that is my turn.
We still use the bird on the guy.
Yes, Cher, it is your turn to control birds.
Okay. Wait, do you want me to use my bird on the leader, then?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think
okay. Then I am going to use my bird on the leader. Attack my silver eagle.
Alright, I think you should be able to move it. I gave you ownership. Maybe.
How do I...
Space
Are you
bar.
Using the ruler tool right now?
Yes.
You push spacebar after you. You kind of pull out your ruler, and then you push spacebar. Is it not working?
Spacebar?
Oh, that does work. Let me move back real quick.
Oh, and then, wait,
space.
Okay.
You have to click on them, too.
Okay, and then space, and then... Does not work! Okay.
Alright, on top of the leader, like dude, normal. Yeah. I gotcha.
And then...
Figure that one out later.
Save you some time if you push the
Well, my up. Enter isn't working. There we go.
Awesome. Hey. And yes, that does hit. Give me your damage.
Yeah. 10d12
plus 47.
1d4 plus 2, I think you said the damage was?
Yeah. It's not wanting to.
If you push the up arrow, by the way, it pulls up your previous macros.
Yeah, I know. It's not... Why is it not... Hang on, I might have to refresh. I don't know if you can hear me, but I keep on pressing enter, it won't go.
Oh, yeah, push F, yeah, F5. 1d4 plus 2, yeah. Double checking.
That might be why I couldn't move my bird either, I don't know what's going on.
Oh, yeah,
maybe,
probably.
Yeah.
Want me to roll it for you?
Yeah, now might. It's not even...
Might as well.
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright, 3 points of damage to this thing as it gets clawed. Slash, slash. Not having a good time. Let me put it back on top. Just as a note, this is a small thing, so just a thing to you. You don't need to be on the square, you can be 5 feet away from it and still do the same damage.
Oh, okay.
Give you up. Just for the future. For your sake. Poutine!
You may want to hold your turn until after mine if you're going to be moving towards Tangent.
Putin's gonna look at you.
At least until after the Kelpies.
Putin's gonna nod, and she's gonna hold her turn until...
After the Kelpies, because Tangent might run into the water if you don't.
Until just before our Tangent.
Just before Tangent, alright. Alright, got you moved. It is this one's turn, who is squinting at Poutine with the most vitriol in their face. Bards are apparently not these things' best friends right now. And moves this way, swish, 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 with an evil glare all the way here to Poutine. Evil, evil, evil. This one stays a little bit closer, just in case, look at that. And this one heads up. Right over here. 5 foots. We'll attack to you, Miss Dayspring.
Oh, rude.
11 and 21.
And the 21 hit.
You take 21. 6 points of damage.
21.
Alright. How you looking there?
Looking spicy.
Alright. Let me see, which one was this one? Gotta search around for my Kelpies now. Oh, that was that one. Alright, Poutine. It's your turn.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
First, I'm gonna move.
Alright, which would give Tangent another save based on your performance roll for this round.
But I guess I'm going to double move.
And also, Grot.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, you both guys go with, get a save equal to whatever Poutine's performance roll is.
Let's see. 15 15, so I have to make a 15?
No, that was the performance roll here. And he barely snaps y'all out of it.
Oof.
Alright. And is Tangent also coming back?
Yes, both of them.
Alright, as a free action, I release the grapple. So we are no longer grappled.
Should I cast Silence? I guess I'll ask that on my combat turn. Talking is a free action, right? As long as we're not using too many words.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. When it's my turn, I'm going to say, should I cast Silence?
Wait, you could have just axed this that out of...
You can also just do it in, during turns. Just keep it short, of course.
I would say hold once we get Grub and Dayspring in our circle. If you cast Silence about right here, that'll make a nice big quiet circle that'll hit most of them, and then we can escape.
Yeah.
I'm actually like right in range of that. I could take like a two-step and then cast it.
Yeah, you can't be in another person's square.
Oh. I mean, I can be here, can't I?
You can, but we're going to be heading for the tree line as soon as we're all together, and we're going to grab that box by Grot and go.
What about this room?
I'll be over there by the time we start going.
They'll be fine. Don't worry.
Dayspring isn't the slow pony.
Okay. So are you guys taking your action? Do you want me to hold my action?
I think she's asking you, what is your recommendation here, Moonplanter?
Yeah, cast it.
Cast it now? Okay, yeah. And then I go here.
Are you...
I don't think you need to be that close.
Yeah, you don't need to be that
close.
You
can cast it from right there.
Oh, alright. Okay, cast Silence.
Is Silence a short range spell?
Yeah.
You could cast it there, and that'll get everybody in trouble.
Give me a moment to find the spell. Alright, range. Oh, it's long. It's really long. 20 foot radius.
Then, yeah, I would say cast it. Let's see. If you cast it there.
Here?
Actually, yeah, cast it right there. I think that would be a good
spell. Yeah, this is where I'm going to cast it.
Will Silence stop them from just directly looking at us running away?
Upon the casting of the spell, complete silence prevails. All sound is stopped. Spells with verbal commands cannot be cast. The spell is centered on a creature. An unwilling creature can attempt a will save.
What it will do is it'll prevent them from singing at us, and they won't be able to entrance us into the water. At least the group inside the circle can't.
And what's your DC again?
How do I find out my DC?
It's the same.
14.
Spell level plus wisdom.
Okay. Oh, then it's still the... I mean, 13. My wisdom is still 13. The same, so yeah. It's plus 2.
Alright, we'll negate. So they just have to roll above 13. Let's see.
Oh, well, that's a level 2 spell, so it would be 14 on that one, then.
Alright. How many do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alright.
Can I cast it again?
All right. Which
most of them
doing top to bottom here. This one I'll just mark the ones that that had failed. That will be silent. I'll put like a silent scream. Look at that. That one failed. This one failed. Do 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 thunk. Look at that. This one failed right over here. That was stunned. No longer stunned, but that one was only a round effect. Same with this one. And succeeded. Alright. Failed.
Same time as one round? Damn it. That's my action.
You can still move, though.
Can't? What, a 5-foot action?
Alright.
No, you can, let's see.
I already moved to be here, though.
Wait, yeah, casting time one round, I see that. So yeah, you could take a 5-foot step.
All right,
yeah, but I'll just be back where I was.
Alright, it is your friend, Rop's turn over here. Who looks torn between helping Warboss and running.
Warboss is going to look back and point towards the others.
He gives you the greatest look Gobbo can give. And sprints this way. Let's see, as far as his little Gobbo legs can take him. Whee! Which is about that far.
All right, friends, I'd love to stay in chat, but it's bingo night.
Whee! He does get a...
No, I'm withdrawing.
Okay, I was like... All right.
You can't really move.
All right. It is, one of these, which one is it? Nope, gotta escape. There's so many things going on this map at once. It's the silenced ones over here's turn. As you see them very confusedly go up here, swish through the water, poke up their head, and start to sing. But no sound comes out.
They failed their spellcraft.
Grot. You have snapped out of it.
Ugly sing.
And Grot is gonna keep going.
Alright, half your movement up. How far does that get you?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Warboss, come on, these too weak for you.
Yeah, I agree.
Alright. It is Mr. Leader Guy's turn. This is going to give your eagle an attack of opportunity here. They're Milliminous as he swims this way. Swoosh, 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 swoosh. All the way up here. Swoosh, 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 swoosh.
Uh-oh.
So give me that attack roll for your eagle, Milliminous.
Yeah, so I would love to do that. Unfortunately, I am apparently on Windows 98. So?
What?
This is on my fucking animation computer downstairs. I'm just remoted into it, and it's like, it's just freezing up. I can't do anything.
You're all wrong.
Now I literally can't do anything.
Close the anniversary stream, dude. That's what's eating most of your RAM right now.
I don't even have it up.
All right. Was that the roll, Dayspring, that you wanted to help?
Yeah, I did the roll for Milliminous.
All right. I did miss.
No! Dayspring, why?
Yeah.
What? Damn it.
However, poor leader guy here does need to give a will save as he had entered the zone of silence. How dare he?
Can't fail your will save.
I can't even sign in on my main computer because I'm signed in here.
This one had poked his head above the water, took a deep breath, and screamed silently at you. He looks like a very angsty teenager, let me tell you.
All right. Quiet Reese in the distance.
Yes, yes.
Lean in my skin.
This one over here does the same thing, looking at Moonplanter. Whoosh, whoosh, as he comes up here to try to sing silently. They start looking at each other really awkwardly, like, what the hell is happening?
Does anyone have any area of effect spells?
Area of
effect? We could nuke them right now.
This one right here, who is, I should take this this status on them, they don't have an enthralled anymore, does not sing, in fact, sees that all his friends are silent, and that's scary. That's spooky. Whoosh. You don't like that? No, sir.
No, sir.
This one, however, gives it his best shot as he pulls up his horsey head to sing, and a sound is heard because he made his save. Poutine.
Me? Oh no.
Me?
Yeah, you.
I mean, Poutine's been doing pretty good. He's been coming in clutch today, honestly.
What? Do you want me to do anything?
A will save.
I don't want to.
You're gonna have to give me one.
Well, I mean, even if you fail it, you still get your area of effect.
You barely succeed, my dude.
Good job.
I doot.
You doot. Very dootingly. All right. This one doesn't get their status anymore. And I believe this one already tried, so he can't do you again. However, Oh, you can't do tangent. This one can, however, still sing. Sing at poutine. Oh, no, never mind. No, we cannot. Oh, you're safe for now.
I am.
You are very safe for now. This one raises their horsey head, finds out that they don't have a voice, and are now equally confused that they have heard some of their own kind have a voice, but they do not, as does this one down here. Poor guys. Poor Kelpies. What do you do with that?
I don't feel sorry for them. I hope a lightning strike fries them all.
And this one, flies up here to go assist his mates. Oh no, look what he's entered. Means he needs to get a will save. And he does make it, so this one keeps his voice. Look at that. That was their turns. Moonplanter, it is your turn.
Moonplanter sees an opportunity to escape, so he's going to head for the tree line.
Yes, retreat towards the traps, just in case they follow us.
You know what? Sure. Yeah, we'll head there.
Move yourself.
That is 30 feet. Do I need to move back further? Just double move?
Do you want to move past the traps? Yes.
Alright, I'm going to move there and purposely avoid my snare trap.
Yeah, you can move yourself that way.
Okay.
I believe in you. There you go. You move that way. Share.
Yay!
Be your turn.
You can nuke them. Nuke them.
Well, I had to restart the entire other computer, so now I am on my main computer, and it seems to be smooth now. Yay. I don't know if I can nuke them from my ego, though. Where is my ego?
What is the ego actually like?
It's still back over here. Okay. Do I have any big area of effect attacks? I don't think...
Do you have Fireball?
Fireball!
Yeah, when in doubt, Fireball.
Fireball always works.
Like 3 or 5 spell or something, I forgot what it was.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah,
I'm a squishy squash. Well, I have to pull back up my sheet real quick because I closed the other computer. Yeah, give me just 1 second.
Yeah, Fireball's a level 3 spell, I forgot. What about cone attacks? Something like frost or something like that.
Hang on. Wait, where's my reference sheet?
I'll help you out. I'll help you out here. Your spells. Let's see. What do you have for spells?
I download it every time, so I'm just gonna go to my downloads folder. So here it is.
Oh, which ones do you have prepared, rather?
For prepared, I have. Detect magic, detect poison, magic hand, message opened, and there's cause fear, magic missile, shield, summons monster. And I still have 3 Mangle Sparkle melons. I'm sure those are bad by now.
Probably.
So I don't have any, like, cone attacks, unfortunately.
Unfortunate.
You have 1 in your spell book, but it's not prepared.
Yeah.
Unfortunate.
I can always move
little birdie bird. That is how many feet? That is only 65.
He's flying?
Yeah. And now I can move him. Also, and
technically make it a charge and give him a +2. You
can.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll do a charge and then we'll do... Roll 1d20 +4, then?
Yep. That is correct.
Oh, wait, I didn't mean to make that blind.
No, it's +3, so +5.
Oh, +5.
Oh, +5?
It does hit. So give me that damage roll.
Okay. And that total was roll 1d4 +2. It keeps doing it.
set your thing to public.
Yeah, you have your
It's because I had it set correctly on the other computer. I just moved to this one. So I have to reset everything.
All right, you deal your 4 damage and slash it again. This thing is getting really pissed off at your eagle, let me tell you. It's been nicking away at it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, do you have magic missile also?
I do. I don't know if I can
I mean, there's kind of like
a free action, or is that like a standard action?
Is it?
What? It's already summoned, so unless you have to concentrate on it to command it, you should be able to just.
I didn't read anything that said I did, so. But I mean, you guys are kind of right in the way of magic missile.
It doesn't matter. Magic missile finds its target.
Okay.
As long as you can see it.
Think of it as homing magic missile.
Okay, so for my magic missile, I will. Where's my PDF go?
At your level, it'll be.
I can summon two, I believe.
Yeah, I think that's
third
right.
Third level, yes. Two. At 1d4 plus 1 per missile, so 2d4 plus 2.
Yeah, okay, so I'll attack the boss.
Go for it.
Twice. With magic missile, so it would be 1d4 plus 2, then? 2D, if it's just 2D, the same?
2d4 plus 2.
Yep.
Okay. Roll 2d4. 2d4?
Plus 2.
Yes.
Plus 2.
Nice. Another 7.
Right.
This and guy seems like he has a lot of health.
He is the boss.
Yeah, he isn't, looking very happy, let me tell you that.
They all seem to be roughly comparable to us. Each.
I only have 20 health! I'd be dead by now!
Okay, I'm roughly comparable to the more hardy of us.
Alright, it is this one's turn, who... looks to the big eagle that is attacking the boss and tries to attack your eagle. Whoosh. Swoosh. This one is going off. He is not seemingly liking this one too much. Not at all, friend. It is now this one's turn. Which one is that one? Way over here. One that initially had seduced your friend. He is following the lead of his friends over here. Makes it Poutine's turn.
Where's the box we have to carry?
All the way up here.
Up there with Grot.
Okay, I'm gonna move.
Alright, where are you moving?
I'm moving.
In that direction, you.
And I don't think I'm in range right. Yep.
All right.
I guess I'm gonna double move.
Double move?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
And I'm gonna roll my finger.
Go for it. Nice! If these things try to seduce you guys again, you guys get the save of 27 if you're within his circle.
Nice.
And with the mad dudes. Tangent, it is your turn.
I am going to take my full round action to take my 50 feet twice in a row, so that's going to be 100. And...
there's noping out of there.
Yeah, just getting the heck out of Dodge, so it's pretty much off the map.
Alright.
She's gone.
Alright, fair. Second Gobble.
You knew we were all safe.
Gobble Grop goes over here to start assisting Grot. Grot, when you start pulling the box now, you can move at full speed, as long as he's with you.
Nice.
Yeah.
Teamwork.
Dayspring.
Mini gym for war boss.
Yes, war boss! Dayspring, it is your turn.
Do I throw a rock at him and leave, or do I just leave?
I would say fuck off.
Gobble Grop is looking at you as if, what will Warboss do in such a situation?
What is this?
You gotta throw a rock and leave. You gotta show dominance.
Everyone else is pretty close. I can afford to throw a rock. All right.
Already know. This was his fatal mistake.
Do you have a spell for the rock, like hedging weapons?
Huh?
Do you have a spell for the rock?
Yeah, hang on. Use this.
Oh, based.
Oh, nice.
Alright. You find yourself a 5-pound rock. whoosh it over. Give me that ranged spell attack.
Is that just plus dex or whatever?
No, your ranged spell attack includes other things. Ranged spell attack pathfinder. Oops.
Let me search for that in Hero Labs, because it's probably in there somewhere.
It is. It is in your spells.
Oh, there it is. Range touch? Although it's not a touch attack, but, you know, same modifier probably.
And your spells, it should just say what your plus is to, let's see. Base attack plus dex plus size plus range. I guess that's just a thing. Attack rolls for spells. Yeah, I think it's just the same as normal dex things.
Okay. I do not hit.
You do not.
In fact, I dropped the rock.
I did not hit him. I did not.
Yeah, I didn't.
Well, it still flies into the water. It still goes.
Yeah, yeah.
Woo!
It does a nice little splash.
And
does it do a skip?
You guys hear Grop go, "Splash! Wobbles!" Which, yeah. It's pretty much mimicking exactly what Grot is saying.
We're just cheering over here.
Yeah. All right. This Kelpie can't really do anything. It is silenced and in the water. Grot, take
us home.
I'm
gonna use my full move action to get the fuck out of here.
All right. And as you guys make it the hell out of here, combat is ended.
Wow.
And you guys escaped.
We did it. We won.
If I knew I could have done magic missile while doing it, it would have been probably so much easier.
Did we win, or did we change our minds halfway through?
We won!
We won!
Yeah, we did get the box!
Yeah, we got their box, and they didn't want us to take it, so therefore we won.
This box is gonna be full of she shells.
Any battle you can walk away from is a battle won.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No plan, let's see, how does the saying go?
No plan survives
contact with the enemy.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought any flight you could walk away from was, or any landing you can walk away from was a good landing.
Yeah, that too.
Crash landing is still a landing.
Oh, guys, let's get the birds last time.
You guys run and run and run, pulling the box with you with the many cheers of both Grot and Grop as they are pulling the box in tandem. So you guys are fairly safely away, far, far enough away from these things.
What's in the box, Mainly?
Do I have an opportunity
What's
to
in the box?
Box? Do you open the box?
Well, that is up to Grot, who holds the box.
Grot is going to give it to the war boss.
War boss, you have received a box.
I shall inspect the war loot.
You open the box and see an amalgamation of things that seem to have just been thrown in there, as if they might have been shifting through. Oh, I should turn off the battle music. Huh? Shifting through the like they just threw in there, going through all the wreckage and the like. And as you do, you find a number of things. Namely, what looks to be 41 gold pieces, 137 silver, and I'll definitely screenshot this for you. A number of gems, some pearly-looking ones, some weird, slightly opaque stones, some turquoise-looking gems, and a lot of weird-looking rainbow-esque stones scattered about. A lot of them.
Aetherstone?
Okay.
It is definitely matching that of the Aetherstone sample that you have.
Ooh, I have Knowledge Arcana. I can roll to make sure I can learn what all of it is.
Go for it. Additionally, you find some artsy objects, some weird sort of sensor with some silver around it.
Oh, it probably should have been private, but oh well.
Yeah, it should be blind.
All right.
As well as what seems to be a very nice polished dark wood chalice. And some additional things. A weird scrolled up item. Two of them, in fact. And
I
a strange stick.
I use a dark wood shield, and I want that chalice.
There we go.
We need some detect magic and spell crafting on the scrolls and the wand.
Mm-hmm.
I can do detect magic too.
Rolls from the both of you would get that, yes, this is a decent amount of Aetherstone.
Nice.
Yay!
We can go back to town if we go quickly.
Yes, and hopefully we don't encounter any more on the way.
Mainly, I'm going to roll a praise on the other objects, such as the gems and the chalice and whatnot.
All right, go
for
it.
Appraise that? I could help.
I need three.
I have a plus six.
If you're appraising, I need three appraise skills from each person appraising. Or you could just take a 10.
I'm giving competence.
Inspiring competence. All right, who's?
Oh, nice.
Wait, hang on. Where's my appraise? Here we go.
I assume he's inspiring Moonplant.
Oops, I didn't mean to make it public, but it still counts, right?
No.
I'm helping you all.
Come on.
All right, between the Inspire Competence, Moonplanter, Dayspring, and you various people. Tangent, you think that this stuff is absolutely goddamn priceless. However, Dayspring and Moonplanter, you get a more realistic sense of what this is. And I will screenshot it and post it.
Wait, what about me?
Sorry, I'm missing rules here. Yeah, you'd also get this, yep. I'm going to... you said you were going to do some magic-y things for the scrolls and things before I take a screenshot of things?
Yeah. Do you have Identify? Because if you have it, you should probably roll the...
I've got Greer Detect Magic.
Regular Detect Magic would work just fine.
Oh yeah, I do have Detect Magic as well.
Detect Magic, and then you'd give me a Knowledge Arcana to try to figure out the spell school, and then from there, roll a Spellcraft to see if you can determine what it is.
So I did Detect Magic, and then I can do Knowledge Arcana again.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, where's my Knowledge Arcana? Here we go. And then Blind GM. There we go.
Alright, and I need one more. Or two more, sorry. There's three magic items in here.
Okay. Knowledge Arcana. Blind GM. And then Knowledge Arcana. Blind GM.
The auras you get are Transmutation, Enchantment, and... Oh, I'm actually not sure about this last one. Let me look up this amount. I just need to double check what this spell school is. Conjuration. You can give me a 3 spellcrafts now to try to figure out what those do in proper fashion.
Yeah, I have spellcraft plus 7, so... Damn, yeah. I'm coming in clutch! I was fucking destroying the boss, now I'm doing this. Me and Dude are just... Man, why are you guys even here?
I'm here to hit things.
Do I have to do that 3 times,
I'm
or...?
I'm here to heal you. By the way, did anyone take any damage? Oh, yeah.
I took a lot. But I can also heal myself.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna go and go heal Dayspring.
Roll your healing while I get the screenshot ready.
I will help you so you don't waste too many spell slots.
I'm actually sacrificing them to cast Cure Light Wounds here.
Alright, I'm gonna post this in documents. This is what you find in the
Cure
chest.
1d8
and their values.
Plus
actually let me
Yay.
Let me take my mouse out of there because that's gonna give me OCD. Alright, hang on.
Okay. Oh wow, 50 pounds of Aetherstone, sweet.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Damn, I can't believe we got 50 pounds of it.
I didn't mean to make that blind.
Okay, so...
Oh, wait, I hit the wrong one.
Okay, so, I don't know, it's blind, so I'm not sure how much I healed.
I'd say to just, like, avoid splitting up all the gold into, like, meaningless, like, small things that, like... Loot gold we just put into one separate pile that we just use for missions.
Dayspring, how much damage did you take?
For that small of an amount of gold? Yeah.
It's 41.
I'm at like 9 health
damage?
Right, well, 18 health right now.
Okay, and wait, you
And that's out of 27.
No, it's 41 gold pieces is what we're talking about.
Yeah.
So I should probably...
We could
again.
Probably reasonably split up the silver as is, I think. Because there's enough of it.
Alright, so that's 14 heal hold right there, plus D springs. What should get her back up?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That will be...
We could sell all this for like 1,048 gold pieces, but... Do you guys want to keep the scroll of the... Can we use the scroll of Detect Evil more than once?
Those scrolls are actually going to be useful for you.
Yeah, just to let you know, as an Arcanist, because I know you're a little bit newer to this system, is if you find scrolls and you don't have the spells in your spellbook, you can copy those scrolls into your spellbook. Regardless if you can cast them at this level or not, you can still put them in there to be able to.
Oh, yay!
Yeah.
I'm gonna steal all these scrolls then.
Copying it into your spellbook, though, does negate the use of the scroll. Because you're effectively pilfering its magical secrets. Like, it
also costs money.
I know it doesn't.
So we're going to take
wait, does it?
It costs to... like the ink cost, which is like 10 gold, I think.
Okay, so cool.
We're going to take the Acer Stone back to Blake's.
Yep.
Turn, right? Yeah. Okay. All right.
Wand of Vault, what exactly does that spell do?
It casts Mount, which let me let's...
Inky.
Yeah,
don't want to post that in there.
It is a communal spell, which means you summon a light horse or a pony to serve as your mount.
Oh, it's Mount Communal?
What was that?
It's Mount Communal?
Oh, no, it's not Mount Communal, sorry.
Oh, okay.
And it comes with a bit, bridle, and riding saddle. How lewd.
So you're a pony riding a pony, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty lewd, Memely. Memely horny posting as DM again.
Ah, damn, you got me. All right.
Here's an idea. We could take our haul here, minus the Aether Stone, of course, sell all of it, and then use that as a community pile, except for the scrolls that...
And the mount. I'm going to steal the mount. We could use that.
That's our biggest... that's the biggest haul we got, though.
Which like means it's probably worth the shit ton for us to keep it if other people want it.
I don't think it is, though. I think we could go ahead and do better with the gold.
Chalice.
Scroll of the Tact.
Oh. Horse. We're all horses.
Now,
we are all horses.
I do think that this is a good time to leave off session here and have this discussion. Have this discussion in the Adventure Planner. However, I think it is high time for a level up.
Ooh. Yay.
Yay! I should get a big body.
I have no idea how to level up in Foundry, but I'll find out.
We'll work on that.
You'll want to do it in Hero Labs and then import the values.
I don't want to import 10,000 things, my guy.
Not import, but just copy the things that change over.
Okay.
So import, Vinport.
Hi.
Yeah. If you want to use Hero Labs to do it, you can, and then just copy the values just by looking and. Typing
it's usually what I do.
Yeah. However, we're gonna go ahead and say goodbye to the stream. Say goodbye, stream. Bye.
Goodbye, stream.